206 shit, nigga. Fuck you thought. Real life.
Jello Beats, holla at me.
I'm a southern nigga raised up in the early 90s. First gun aimed in my head up in the early 90s. I was 7, just got put on in the early 90s. Pushing Ranier, trying to put on for the 39ers. No 49ers or 39ers. Feds raided my house when we was 89ers. That was 96.
So I know we driving on the I-5, and I-5 has been driving for a long, long time, up and down. Why go by the name I-5? What's the concept behind it?
Concept is, my mom, she's from Seattle, and my dad from L.A. So the concept is I grew up everywhere from Seattle all the way down to L.A. And that's where you get the interstate stretching from the top to the bottom, from Seattle really all the way to Dago, which really stretches from Canada to Mexico. But I use the term 20619, because 206 is Seattle's area code, and 619 is San Diego's area code, so you get 20619. That's my nickname, AKA. You feel me? From the top of the interstate to the bottom. You feel me? The whole thing. And the I-5, man, there's so much that's behind that name. Because this is all I did in my life, was go back and forth, up and down the interstate. Getting passed around, different people's possessions, being on my own out there in different states. I've been all over, man, Arizona to everywhere, man. I went to high school in Arizona, I went to high school in Tacoma, Seattle, you name it. I-5, up and down this interstate, man. This is special to me.
Seems like, what's your favorite part about driving on I-5?
Being able to collect your thoughts, you know, so you can make your next move your best move. You niggas might have thought about Seattle, and I don't know what you know about me, nigga. I'ma break this shit down. This a real biography, nigga. Like my biography, nigga. I am from that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I-5, we here on Rainier Beach. Tell me a little something about this motherfucker, bro.
Man, Rainier Beach. You know, I grew up a Rainier Eagle, man. Eagles, you feel me? We're gonna stick to the topic of the motherfucking conversation, you know what I'm saying? The area, man.
Right.
Shout out Rainier Beach, man. Henderson, man. I've been at Holy Moly's, man, forever, man. All my cousins went to Rainier Beach, even though I went to Franklin, man. Rainier Beach area isn't just about the schools. It's about the Little League, man. It's about how you was raised up in the community, man, the Rainier Beach area, man. You feel me? It's about everything that happened right here. All these apartments right here, man. My cousin stayed in all these apartments, man. It was all black down here, man. You didn't have no Europeans around here. You feel me? Hell no. There wasn't no white folks out this motherfucker. It was all Samoans, blacks, and Asians. You feel me? And you gotta love it, man, because it was a wonderful community, man. Rainier Beach is one of those places that you think of when you think of all your athletes, basketball, all your football stars, man. They come right up out of Rainier Beach, man. We put out the best, man. You feel me? Selfish, straight up. You know, but there's a difference, though, because Franklin, that's Columbia City, like I told you earlier. You Columbia City, baby, you go to Franklin. If you're a motherfucking Henderson, baby, or Holly, baby, you went to Rainier Beach. So I had hella cousins I used to have to play at Rainier Beach. You know, we smacked them, you know what I'm saying? We smacked them, bro. I'm telling you. Back in the day, it was 1996, man. Our championship, we had to play the Rainier Beach Vikings, man. Do you know that? There goes 89 and Sweet Pea, Banner, Midget, Pee Wee, from youngest to highest. We had to play they Sweet Peas when we was 89ers because the 89ers didn't want it. That's a little dirt on Rainier Beach, man. Just a little comedy for those who don't know, man. Straight up. But Rainier Beach, I love this area, man. This is one of the only areas, man, where you're still gonna see a lot of black people, you feel me? Even though they put the worst type of food in the community in Rainier Beach.
Hey, tell me a little bit about that. Let me know a little bit more about that. What's going on?
Well, basically, genetically modified foods and high corn starch and all this other extra shit, man. It all pretty much made its way into our community. Always been here.
Right.
It's always been a thing that stagnated our growth.
Right.
Because we never took a chance to study what is in these GMO foods. What's in the stuff they put in our community besides the alcohol and the drugs? What about the things that you're just going to buy for your kids that you just write off as, oh, it'll be all right. Some Skittles, you know, whatever. Not even understanding the shit that's up in that package. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
What you don't know is they have labs where they engineer all these chemicals that they pump into the foods and then they put them into the neighborhoods like Rainier Beach.
Yeah, I remember you telling me stuff like that. That's the reason why we don't see too many Whole Foods around here.
Fuck no, you don't see no Whole Foods. The only time they go and build Whole Foods is when they knock down some shit and they move some Europeans in like they did to Columbia Plaza in my hood in Columbia City. Other than that, they don't give a shit what we eat or drink, period. All they gotta do is wake up in the morning, smile to you, say, hey, how are you doing? Open the door every once in a while, talk to you about the Seahawks, and this shit is all good.
Man, but my bad for cutting you off right there. I just kind of wanted to stay a little bit more on topic as to the foods. Man, what's going on with all the vegetable oil?
Man, vegetable oil, safflower oil, canola oil, all them oils, man, those are all unnatural processed oils. They do so much to them goddamn oils before we touch them. It clogs your intestinal flora. It's terrible for everything. It'll shut down your pineal gland, which helps you operate from your frontal lobes. It helps you with decision making and the confidence within yourself. You know
right,
what I mean?
Right.
The oils is a piece of shit, and it's in all the fucking food that they're serving us, including these fucking foreigners.
And everything. Everything. Yeah. Name what we got. What? They put it on nuts, Cheetos, you name
nuts,
the shit,
Cheetos,
huh?
Cheetos. Man, they put it in any and everything, and you'll find a pattern by studying the nutrition facts or the ingredients on a lot of these foods in our neighborhood.
Righteous.
So, really, Rainier Beach is one of those areas, man, that everybody wants to be to say they're here, but they don't want to do nothing to help Rainier Beach. Are you from the hood? Are you European? You stay in Rainier Beach. You're close to the city. But what have you done for Rainier Beach? That's the new question. What are y'all doing for Rainier Beach?
So is there anybody you could name, like one person that tried to do anything?
For Rainier Beach? No. Hell no. Because you would have built the school, built the library, built something that's gonna help people transition the consciousness they come from the product of their environment, to who they are before that and who they're gonna become. That way everything isn't just studying the present conditions.
So
you see what I'm saying?
So you would say basically they're just trying to leave a lost youth.
That's exactly what they're doing. Whether they're conscious of it or unconsciously, that's what they're doing, a lost youth. Guaranteed. They want us to be just like them. Oblivious to what goes on, desensitized, you know what I mean? It's all about having a nice car, a good job, a big house. Man, that shit don't matter. We spiritual people, man. Feel me? We never needed churches to practice our spirituality. We never needed mosques. We never needed anybody to tell us about who the higher power was above us. It was in us, not outside of us. It was in us. You know
who taught the opposite? Who was teaching and preaching all this other bullshit?
It comes from the mentality of those who are trying to manipulate others so they could jack their spirituality. Get them all worked up. Get them all worked up and feeling good, but they'll never return. Nothing will ever change in their society. Nothing will ever change because you'll never teach them who they are. It's all about who you are.
Right.
You gotta know as a Rainier Beach citizen who you are, a Rainier Beach community person, as a fellow person of Rainier Beach. You gotta understand who you are as a Rainier Beach. You're not just a Rainier Beach, you're a Seattleite. You're not just Seattleite, you're a Native American. You're not just a Native American, you're a Moorish American.
Righteous, righteous. I love it for sure. Hell yeah. Quick shout out to the Rainier.
Yeah, shout out to Rainier, man. Rainier Green and Rainier Beach, even though we in Rainier Beach. Shout out all my cousins from Rainier Beach. Y'all know who y'all is, man. I love y'all to death, man. You know I got 1,000 memories, but I can only speak on camera about one or two. You feel me? I was an 89, I'm playing for the Rainier Green. My backyard was the cut to the Rainier scene. We went to ship in 96 against Rainier Beach. We lost the ship the next year against Rainier Beach. I had to catch the bus from High Point to Rainier. I-5 out here in the South and in Rainier Beach on motherfucking Notorious Henderson. Y'all know where it's at. Out here with the homies and my cousin Kate. You feel me? You already know, H Block official. Holly Pool.
You know what it is, H Gang, man.
You already know.
South Dance Partners out here, man. You know, doing this shit, man. South Dance.
You feel me?
You know, my cutty I-5, man. You doing this shit, man. You know. it's a positive movement, so you know, just gonna keep everything positive. You know, I'm gonna leave it at that. You feel me?
Righteous.
HP, man, Holly Pooh, man, high percentage, you know what I'm saying? Mr. All Purpose, you know, this is what we do, South End business. H-Gang, that's what we do. You know, 206, Emerald City, man, look at this shit. It had to be a good day, man, for my guy, I-5, man. It's sunny and shit, it's gonna be raining in the town. He done brought the sun out in this bitch, huh?
You showed up, showed up. You know? Yeah, man. Like I told you, it's an all-cultural feel, man. Motherfuckers around me, man, these the same motherfuckers who've been here since knee-high, man. You feel me? I grew up, man. My sister dropped me off over there. Man, I used to go all through this motherfucker, Rainier Beach, all the way up to Columbia City, man. And it was always a cultural feel, like I told you earlier in the documentary. It was all family, so they might show all the bad shit, but the bad shit, they don't show the good shit. You know what I mean?
Right.
They don't give you not even the smallest percentage of what it was to be a South Ender.
Man, so let me know a little bit about the South End then from the perspectives, you know, what's it like? What's it like to be man, actually since just being out here, you seen your folks, how you feel about that, man? You know, it's
feels good, cuz. You can't look at everybody. I got three cousins doing life, another big homie doing life, my dad doing life. I got, you know, a lot of niggas is catching L's. You feel me?
Yeah.
So when you see people, you gotta embrace, you gotta
love.
Love.
It's all love.
You don't know next time you gonna see a motherfucker. It could be
just gonna be behind them bars, nigga, or in that box, nigga.
Or in that box.
Never know.
So
life to show.
So times like this, these are the memories. At the beginning of my career, even though I'm not at the beginning, at the beginning, you know what I'm saying, where nigga taking that flight.
Right.
You remember this shit, man, before all the glamour and all that shit, you know what I mean? Right here.
Before the chains, whips, and things, we was on the block walking, you know? Fuck it. Or Metro, we gonna catch the 7 to downtown. Or the 42, we can't hop on the 48. That's gonna take us to the city. We can't go over there. But it's the police done dropped us off over there a couple of times. I had to run up out of there, you know, something.
Yeah, speaking of the 48, I'm telling you, speaking of the 48, y'all don't know about the infamous 48. Niggas like me was from the South End, they know me from way back. Man, I used to have to catch that motherfucker from Majorna Middle School. I was the only nigga who didn't get off on Cherry, so they already knew. They're like, he's still going. That nigga going to Rainier. You feel me? That 48, this is Seattle culture, man. Our buses, our metro buses, man, you could do everything on the metro bus. Everything from shooting dice to just chopping game, man. Good knowledge, you know what I mean? Everything.
Hell yeah. Hey, you were saying something before off the camera talking about moving a little bit smarter, you know, especially when we shoot documentaries. This is for the youngins, you know, that want to act, you know, kind of show off. Let's put it like that, just to keep terms simple.
Righteous. Yeah. Like I said earlier, man, you can expose them to what you want, but man, when you incriminate you and your team, man, feel me? When you calling moms and you trying to get green dots and you trying to get all that shit and bust them spreads, that shit costs money for them dumbass shit that you be doing. Everything costs. Everything costs. Whether you invest into something good or it's gonna be something that costs you bad from what you exposed. Everything costs. Never forget. You feel me? So what you expose on that camera is what ATF watching, DEA, FBI, I know Seattle police is watching me right now. Fuck them too. But I'm telling you at the end of the day, need to know basis. Need to know basis.
So it's lightening up the mood a little bit. Any old memories, man? What's some good old memories? Again, certain things y'all can talk about, you know what I'm saying?
Shit.
45-07 South Holland. 44-14 South Holland. You know, we got addresses that we all use from the hood. Three addresses, man, that everybody from the hood was able to use, and no one was ever denied that address.
That's the truth.
You know what I'm saying? It didn't matter whose house it was. If you was from the hood, you was welcome to the three houses.
And that's where we're taking them later on, man. I took them there earlier. We're going to go back. And I told
them, man, you got to go to the J's.
That shit changed, man.
You got to go to 44. You got to go to 4507.
You used to not want to walk down that street.
44.
Then you got to go to Grandma Doc.
You already know. As long as you had one of them three, man. And we was back and forth from them spots, man.
Right.
Man, that shit was lovely, though.
What were you saying, my brother?
I was saying, man, that street, man, South Holly Street, man. Motherfuckers didn't even want to come down that block, man.
Not
literally.
At all.
And I mean that. You can ask any real South End Seattle nigga out here, nigga, that was out here, nigga, in the 90s, nigga.
In the 90s.
You feel me? And I was just a nigga, tiny tiger, you feel me? nigga, watching the OGs do this shit, nigga.
They didn't want to come down Holly. They didn't want to ride past.
Come on, they didn't want to ride past.
They brought MLK and Holly. They didn't hit right here. And all they hit Seward Park.
Bus stop. They get off the bus stop 2 blocks down. Yeah. Motherfuckers live on Holly. Get off the bus 2 blocks down just to walk up the back street to get home. You know,
like Jay. So yeah. Well, basically what he's saying is when you see a motherfucker this age with that on his, you know, I come on off, but you see a nigga that age like that, nigga, it take a lot of skill and a lot of ease, a lot of some more shit, you know what I'm saying, to still be here. You feel me?
Because we know how to move, we move right. When you start moving wrong, you start moving with other niggas that ain't, you know, like nowadays, for instance, everybody say bro. That ain't even his bro. He don't even know that nigga's mama. You know what I'm saying? Nigga's mama don't even like you. Mm. How's that your bro? Everybody from the hood, they can go to anybody's house.
Yep.
Mom, grandma, aunties, cousins, they gonna be like, oh, he from the hood, he's good. You know what I'm saying? Cause they know everybody back in the 90s was family. It wasn't just my bro. We didn't have to say my bro. That's, you know what I'm saying? What's up, family? Or what's up, cuzzo? Or whatever. It was never that bro shit, man. Fuck all that, cause that bro shit can go a long way. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, that's why we still here. We move right. When he left, I left. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. If somebody else left with him, no one moved by themselves. Period, point blank. When you go home, we sit out front till you go in and lock the door and say, and hit us and say it's good. Then we gone. You know what I'm saying? That's just how we move. Other niggas that wasn't doing it, look how many dead homies they got.
It was just
weird shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, they was all the younger generation.
Yeah. And through all that, we still trying to breed this next generation.
Yeah.
You know, that's where my mind is really at, breeding this next generation. You gotta be sharper, smarter, everything. You gotta be better, because if your generation don't get better by it, you're only getting weaker. There's only two ways. You can get weaker than the niggas who came before you, or you can be stronger, mentally, spiritually, and physically. You feel me? Yeah. Put your hoodie on, nigga, this is 206. Tryna fit the 97 to the new 06. All a nigga really need is like 2 more licks. All my South niggas really tryna do those licks. All my South niggas really like blue nose pics. Cause all my South niggas really tryna move those zips. All my city niggas really tryna move those zips. All my city niggas really tryna move those zips. So, man, this is another spot that I grew up right here on Cloverdale Block, man. Shout out to my Dale Block niggas, you feel me? But I stayed on Cloverdale before Dale Block, you feel me? And we gonna shoot through this motherfucker. I'm gonna show you where it went down in this alley. This alley is my backyard. It's the infamous school everybody know, nigga. And I'm gonna take y'all through this bitch, show you my grandma's house. It's still her house to this day. And she owned this little property. She bought it for hella cheap back in the day. We stayed in this motherfucker when there was no electricity, cold as fuck, nigga. It was hood too, hood around this bitch. Let me show you what I'm talking about though. So this is the alley right here, man. Come catch your phase back here. Any issue you got, you come take it back here. You feel me? You can meet me behind my house is what I would tell people. Yeah, it looks so different, I can't barely tell which house is mine. I think they rebuilt all this shit, so I can barely tell which one is mine. We gotta go from the front. What's going on, man? Oh, no, we ain't taking pictures of the car. I'm a rapper. This is my documentary. This is my house. I've been here forever. This is my grandma's house. Yeah, we've been here since forever. You know us? No? You don't? Yeah, my grandma Brown. You don't remember me as a young dude?
I came back from New York.
Oh, so you're not from here?
Yeah, my girl, that's my aunt.
How long she been here?
10, no more.
Yeah! To the front. I'm gonna take y'all to the front of this shit. And it's crazy, they fixed it up so good. You know what I'm saying? Well, not too good, but they fixed the motherfucker up so nicely. You know what I'm saying? I could barely tell which house is mine, yeah? This shit is crazy, man. We gotta go from the front, man. Let me show you. But this the alley where we're at. Damn. I love this shit, man. I swear to God. Let your destination stop on that flight. Don't make a reservation, hop on that flight. And feel the elevation top of that flight. Between me and you, what's the difference is I got no support for my dividends. Who are all not as but my fucking self? You don't fuck with me, then go fuck yourself. Keep the 45 on that fucking shelf. You better do the same to protect your health. I'll be damned if I let them disrespect my wealth. I'll be damned if I let them disrespect my health. We moved over here when I was like 11. You feel me? Yeah, I think it was like 1999 or so. 98.
Okay.
Right there, 98. 99.
So how long you stayed on this block?
Yeah, for hella. Off and on, you know what I'm saying, for hella. My grandma still owned this house. I stayed here for hella, but I was always into shit. So I couldn't just be at one location. We had spots. I had different places. My grandma owned another house too. So you feel me?
So which one, where we going to right now?
This is right here. This is where I stayed at right here. This is my old house. My grandma still owned this house. And I don't know who stay here now, but this is where it all started, man. How you doing, sir?
Good, I am. Good, my name.
So I-5, what's your most significant experience that you went through when you were out here?
My most significant experience out here, man. Well, this neighborhood right here was a lot of poverty, you know what I mean? I remember my grandma, man, she would cook and she would give plates to everybody. I remember the squirrels would get everybody would get a plate. Excuse me, not the squirrels, the raccoons would get a plate. I remember everything was fed. Everything from the animals to the people. I just remember everybody being fed. And that's really what I remembered about this, because sometimes we didn't have no electricity. It was cold as hell. We had to sleep in here. You feel me?
Right.
So I remember times like that where it was freezing, where we could blow fog in our house.
And they get as cold as fuck out
cold
here in Seattle.
Cold as fuck in Seattle, cuz. So when the electricity go off, you know, my grandma, she from Omaha, she country, it ain't nothing. She grew up poor, real poor. So we were second level poor. We weren't even as poor as her, because, you know, you're supposed to gain progress little by little. So we was blessed poor, and then my kids ain't gonna be poor at all. That's how you gotta move. Well, I remember my grandma feeding everybody, man. I remember everybody getting a plate, neighborhood peoples, everybody, man, you know what I'm saying? The homeless people, and that was one of the most significant experiences of being right here, man. Besides all the South End, all the different things that was going on as far as drama-wise, I'm just talking about seeing how everybody was taken care of, you know what I'm saying? No matter how much we didn't have much. Let me take y'all back through the alleyway, man, where it all went down. This is my room in the back. So once again, just like 3918 South Brandon, I can look through my window and I can see anybody who was out here, straight up, from here to the school parking lot. So I always had a good position to catch you motherfuckers slipping. No, I'm just playing.
So hella shit went down back here in the back, huh, in this little alleyway.
Oh, in this little alley, everything goes down, man, from clucks out here, you know. A cluck is a fiend, if you ain't know. You know, that's a knock, a cluck, a fiend, you know what I'm saying? A jug, they be back here, have brawls back here, everything going on back here, you feel me? Little gang meetings and stuff back here. I ain't gonna speak on who, what, when, and where, but
it went down. It went down.
Yeah, you get the where, but not the who, what, and the when, you know what I'm saying? Right here, this is where it went down.
Shit, man, what would you say? This
is where I'm talking about.
This word all got started for I-5, huh?
Right here, man. This is new. This new ass deck. Man, I wish I would have had a deck back then. They just built that motherfucker. My room was right here. Feel me? Right there. It was popping, man. These are like real hood spots, my nigga, where I grew up. You feel me? It was going down. You couldn't be no pussy. You couldn't have an inch of pussy. I'm talking about you couldn't have a motherfucking grandma pussy in you. If you had a grandma pussy in you, my nigga, you was
it was bad for you around here. You feel me? You need to fight your way up the street. You know what I'm saying? But right, besides so all that, it was still cultural. Everybody was able to eat. Everything was good. You know what I mean? Everybody was tied in. All families around here, we all know each other. You feel me? You just say the last name of the family. That's how we do in the South End. What's your last name? Oh, you a Smith. Oh, you a Jefferson. Oh, you a McLean. Oh, you a Brown. Like me, I'm a Brown. Oh, okay, I know who you is because the older generation went to school with them. And it's a generational thing. Well, when they come through with gentrification, they hire the property taxes, so you gotta sell your shit like my grandma and my grandfather did. Mm-hmm. What happens is they move people in, there's no more cultural field. They are now on a land that they are not indigenous to. They don't know nothing about the memories of that. You feel me? They see it for the books. We right. see it from our memories and our heart. You see what I'm saying?
So now nobody really knows each other. Nobody's really talking to each other on a cultural tip.
Exactly. No one's talking to anybody because it's uncomfortable.
Right.
You feel me? You know that you come from a whole nother area. You moved over here in our areas and you know why. It would be different if you just moved over here. You moved over here based on, you know what I'm saying, a systematic financial plan to get us out of here. So you can be closer to the city, even though y'all ain't from the city. We the real Seahawks. You feel me? How you gonna say Seattle Seahawks and y'all ass from motherfucking Bellevue? We talking about Seattle, King County right here. You know what I'm talking about? Inner city, you feel me?
Man, it's just cold, man. It's a cold ass fucking game right there. How the fuck they, how do they allow that shit to happen though?
Shit, they allow it to happen because the banks own the homes. If you want a home, you gotta go through a bank, and they control property taxes going up or down. Sometimes, as you know, in Seattle, your property tax will be higher than your mortgage. You know what I mean? Or your house would be fully paid off.
Yeah,
it's all paid off.
But you're still paying.
But you're still paying on property taxes, which is equivalent to the price of your mortgage. You feel me? And people can't pay. And then as they hire it more, it may have exceeded what your mortgage was when you were trying to pay, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
When you were paying to own, renting to own your shit. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And then they come and they drop your price like, here, this is what we'll do. We'll pay for this. Don't worry about it. We're gonna offer you this, which a little bit of fucking nothing. You're talking to a person who is a part of this. Feel me? Like my grandpa dealt with this. My grandma dealt with this. This ain't like just other people's situations. You're talking to one who experienced this. I went in the courtrooms and talked to them. I talked to the lawyers, the real estate agents and all the shit. And I'm telling you right now, they fucking sharks and cowards. You know what I'm talking about? They don't give a fuck about your memories, your love, culture, none of that. All they see is moving these Europeans in. All they see is their interests, what they can benefit from. You feel me?
Yeah, we've been going through the city and you've been saying like a lot of old stores and shops and even just in general buildings that you don't even remember no more. They've been knocking schools down and—
Yeah, they knocked down Zion Prep and they knocked down the Columbia motherfucking Plaza. That was like the hood landmark. How you gonna knock down the Columbia Plaza?
Shit.
We couldn't get no healthy food. Everything we eat is bad for us. Whether it's GMO, candy, sweet, that
right.
is a healthy, it's supposed to be at least.
Right.
You feel me? Look at the ingredients on the back of that shit, it seemed like that.
Right.
As healthy as they say they is anyway. But the concept is we eat healthy. We want a clean atmosphere for where we live at. But that wasn't for us though. Y'all couldn't do that for us. When it's us, y'all flood the drugs and the guns in this motherfucker.
Right. And
it shows you the difference. Nothing personal. This is something that should be studied. You feel me? Without your personal emotion. Even though people like me, we can't get rid of our emotion because the way that they designed it, we have to go through emotional things.
Right.
Because of that. So for us to distinguish the emotional part from the part that's actually affecting us from a law way, from a systematic way, feel me? That's hard for us to do. And then we gotta stare at y'all motherfuckers every day and y'all want us to be cool and act like ain't shit happened, like it's all good? Y'all want us to accept that reality? That's why it's foul. You don't do that. That's unfair to make us accept the reality, you feel me, that y'all want us to live in. That's pathological to us, period. And that's how I feel, man, straight up.
Gentrification at its finest. Fuck. Hell yeah.
Cloverdale, man. Right now, we on Ranier Avenue in Austin Street. This is my old house, me and my brother Jerk Luck from Holly. You feel me? We used to stay up here. My room was at the very top. We was here for years. I was young, 16, 17. Man, we had spots. I lived here. I lived across the street. I'm gonna take you over there in a minute. That's the Austin Street apartments right here. You feel me? Then we stayed in the Fontanelles right here. And then we stayed in the, apartments right here too. So basically, I stayed everywhere on Ranier and Martin Luther King Way, you feel me? And Ranier especially, you feel me? But man, there's so many memories from right here, man. Not just the hustling. Man, as you can see once again, I'm in the top room. I can see anybody out here and what they was fucking doing. You feel me? So, I mean, always having good access point by the grace of God. Maybe that's why I never got my motherfucking house shot at. You know what I mean? That's, I always knew who was around, when to come outside, who was out here, all that. You feel me?
Just to tell me about a little bit of the shit that went on around here.
Man, everything went on around here, you feel me? There's a lot of gang truces, you know what I'm saying? There was a lot of us seeing the kids, they had to go to school. So me and my brother Dricklow put together this shit to where we was like, you know how niggas is pitching, you know what I'm saying? All the D-boys, we told them, don't make bust jugs around the kids. You feel me? Don't bust jugs around the kids. Don't pop your bottle and drink it around the kids. Don't smoke the blunt around the kids. And Raylock and Dreylock, Dricklow was the ones who pushed that. You feel me? Me and my brother, you feel me? Me from 39, my brother from Cali. And we pushed that to where the kids wouldn't be exposed to the gruesomeness,
right,
of what's going on. Niggas getting stomped out bloody. You feel me, motherfuckers getting shot the fuck up. We made sure when there was kids around, we would be a lot more, you know what I mean? We'd be a lot more smoother, man. We'd be considerate of the things that they're gonna see, that they're gonna be influenced by, you feel me?
Try to show them a different way, right?
That's right. And this is a California family who moved here, who is my, basically my brother's girl was from California, and they stayed here, and this was their grandma. But this is the back where we do all the barbecues and all that shit, you know what I mean? Sacking up shit too.
So, the neighborhoods looked a lot different than what we just seen right now, would you say?
Yeah, most definitely. But what I'm saying is, there's nothing wrong with building your half-ass nice glass studios and all these new condos and whatnot. That's not my issue. My issue is not the niceness. We don't have a problem with how nice it looks. We have a problem of when you chose to make it nice.
Right.
And what happened before it's cause and effect. What happened before the effect of seeing these nice condos? What was the cause of it? What was lost for what gain? And whose gain?
And whose gain, exactly.
You feel me?
That's the
biggest
question.
Whose gain? Because I didn't gain shit from it. Fuck you mean. The shit that they're doing to the Rainier Beach, everything they're doing makes it cost more to do things. You feel me? Cost more. When this is a low income area, period. Only time you was getting good money is if you work for Metro, or you work for Microsoft, or you work for one of these big companies.
Shit, show me a little bit more as to what was going, you know, how you was living out here in this spot.
Well, this is where me, my cousin T, Dricklow, we all slap box out here. That's the thing we do in the South End, you feel me? Slap box, you know what I'm saying? We practice our hands back here. Nigga, you know what I'm saying? We do that shit out here. You know what I'm saying? Shit like that. Niggas was slap boxing. So everybody would come back here and we would slap box. That's what we do. Slap box it's a friendly box that you do to practice your maneuvers. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, everybody.
So have your head right. Because if you use your knuckles, you ain't gonna look right for the ladies. You'd
right.
be busted up.
Right.
You know, slaps are all on the face. You know what I mean? Unless you get really smacked hard. But then that's what kicks off. But slap boxing is the culture in Seattle. And my brothers and us, we would come back here and we would slap box. All of my cousins, we would come back here and slap box. Just friendly. And that's all it would be. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Man, that was one of the barbecues, slap boxing, and shooting dice is pretty much the main activities that would go on back here. You know what I mean? And up there in the house, you know, it was food going in and out. You know what I mean?
Mm.
So we had a barbecue feel. It was like cooking all the time. Even though it's rainy in Seattle, we barbecue in the rain. We don't give a shit. You know what I'm saying? The weather ain't going to stop us from enjoying ourselves. You see the grill over there.
Like that, huh?
You know what I'm saying? I guess the culture's still here. You know what I mean? But other than that, man, that's what we would do back here, man. Me and my cousin. Matter of fact, here one of my cousins coming up right now. He was here when I stayed here.
What's going on?
Tech International.
What's happening, man? How you doing, loved one?
Good. This is Shake. It's my cousin right here.
The real ones. Yeah, you know. know, another border in the South End, man, you know. Just out here really reminiscing, man. You know, you look around here, man, it look a real bear around here, man, because we lost a lot of homies around here, man. You know, due to, you know, fuckery and, you know, other shit, man, you know. So, we just out here really just, you know, paying homage, man. You know? For real.
This is where me and my cousin Tech used to stay. This is back in like 06. What was it, like 06? 05?
Yeah, longer than that.
06?
About 06.
Okay, so back in 06, man, motherfuckers was moving and, you know, doing other activities going on in here, you know what I'm saying? And I remember they raided one time and we didn't even want to get down. They had to force us to get down. They raided in that bitch, remember? Yeah, and we were still standing like, nigga, this is where we live. We're not getting down. We not doing nothing. We rolling a blunt, shooting dice, nigga, find the niggas you looking for. They're like, we need you to get down. I'm like, I'm not getting down. You feel me? I'm going to show you where all that shit happened right now, man. We're going to take it to the Austins. When we was here, this was the most drug-infested apartments in the South, and I repeat, the most drug-infested. More than the Ville, more than the Fontanelles, anything. Because I stayed in the Fontanelles, too. We're going to take you there later.
Think you understand me? Fontanelles to the Austins. Cloverdale, understand me? I'm a real-life hitter. Real life spitter. Can't no bitch up in the city say I ain't a go-getter. Can't no nigga up in the city say I ain't a go-getter. Mr. Did it, flip it already, yeah, so good. Quick,
real. So right here, man, we used to be right here on top of these roofs right here. You know what I'm saying? As young little niggas, 13, 12, I had to jump all the way down here just to get away from Officer Nelson and Shuttles. You know what I'm saying? For real, man. I mean, top ninja shit.
Yeah, top ninja shit for real. This is where, you know, clutch, we call them clutch. We see the clutch come up right here, you know what I'm saying? And certain individuals will take care of the activities that they felt were necessary to take care of. I'm gonna show you one of the R window in the back, you know. So we can see once again, this is the fourth or fifth time I showed you, we always had access to see who was around us, you feel me? You niggas take notes, you feel me? I know that law enforcement watching, but guess what, we watch better. This is my old apartment right here. And the back window, you know what I'm saying? You would just be able to come and, you know, receive what you need to receive, whatever kind of packages, you know what I'm saying, the UPS might be, you know, having at that time, you know what I mean? And we would be able to see everybody out here. You would come through from the park. Don't forget these. You feel me? From here all the way on up, right near, major traffic, you know what I mean? But it was a cultural feel still through all that, through all the bullshit and all the grimy shit. You see, it was still love.
And that's the shit that they don't really get to see. They don't talk about it at all.
It's a bond that's unbreakable.
Right.
I'm still with the same people, same ones. You know, through all the gentrification, property taxes being raised. Man, we all split. None of us stay here in Seattle, let me tell you that. I don't stay in Seattle no more. You feel me? Most of us don't stay in Seattle no more. They pushed us all in other directions. But we still is locked in. Still locked in. You feel me?
It's still home.
It's still home.
This is home. This is where we come from. Our stomping grounds, where we live. This is where we've been.
Tell them.
We live and breathe Seattle.
Straight up.
We live and breathe the South End.
Straight up.
It don't leave. It don't stop. You know what I'm saying? It's what we do.
Period.
For real.
You harder, man. We live and breathe this, man. And there's some goddamn good air out here, you know. No disrespect to any other places, you know. But
nah, I'm from the Bay, bro. I'm out here in Seattle. I tell you, bro, I ain't never smelled such fresh air in my life, bro.
You used to be out in Mount Rainier, that, you know. That good fresh.
The Legion star, man. You know, I-5 all the way down, man. You know what I'm saying? We first cousins to the Bay. You know what I'm saying? Everybody, you know, got their legions and, you know, connections and shit.
Yeah.
We gonna keep quiet, you know, stitch lip.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you know, It's all one, you know, all one motion, man. You know what I'm saying? For real, man.
All one movement.
This movement don't stop, man. You know, from down south to the east coast and all the way back, man. It's one movement, man.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? For real.
Believe that. Believe that. And it's just consolidating, that's all, man. You know, we have a different environments, but we all still going through the same thing in different environments. You feel me? It's just a different, a little bit of different lingo. You know what I'm saying? A little bit different prices on packages. You feel me? And but we all related, though, at the end of the day. I'm going to take y'all through this motherfucker so you can actually see it.
Right there, we used to call that the Dirty Dugout.
right there, man.
You know, that's the dirty dugout right there.
The dirty,
man, that hallway right there, man. We call it the dirty dugout, man. You dig? You know what's up, you get in there, man. Either you gonna get dirty or you gonna get laid down, man.
Yeah.
Okay. Dirty dugout, man. Okay. Play ball.
Play ball.
Say I ain't a go-getter. Mr. Get it, flip it already, yeah, so bitter. Quick nigga so bitter, I'm too old bitter. Six on the end of it, bitch don't remember it. Gary Payton's on my feet, Ken Griffey's in the wind. Warm on up in the wind, number one but then again. 2-0 sound better, S-O-U-T-H-E-N, fourth letter. Tryna get the flow cheddar, mixed with the joke cheddar. Focus on this Velveeta, smoking on this 12th letter. The L's keep my health better, scales keep my wealth better. Bruh, I'm about to weigh it up, pass me the thing and I'ma shoot it, I ain't gon' get it.
Nobody would normally chill right here. We would tell people, actually, don't chill right here. Cause this will bring heat to the spot. This is where we would get on the little homies, and I'd be mad as fuck, and they have to hear me because we don't like you being right here. On the inside, cool, but never on the front porch. We tell everybody, don't be on the front porch of the Austins.
Right now, I'm good. Make sure I stay focused.
Straight solid. Austin's. Right here. And of course, we know everybody who stayed in the Cedar Strands. And of course, the homegirls stay right here. And all the partners right here. All the South and homies stay right here. So as you can see, it's not a project, but it was a bunch of low. It's $500 to stay in this month. For what, about 500, cuz? Back in 06?
If that.
If that. 425s and shit, so it's a bunch of low income. You was able to, even if you wanted to just work a job, you would not, everybody was involved in illegal shit. If you want to work a job, you could do that and live here and still survive. You can't do that shit no more.
Swear to God, I be praying, but I ain't playing, bruh. This off my southbound, there's a lane that you should stay in, bruh. At 18, bought my first cater and I was spraying, bruh. So what the fuck, you niggas hollering, what you saying, bruh? Stay observing, I'm lurking behind them bushes. Got 25 different cushions, I granted you niggas wishes. Got 25 different bitches, I'm keeping them out my business. I'm still flexing the muscle, it's still physical fitness. Jehovah is my witness, I'm
riding the family Rogers took you from, we stayed here too. Our family stay right here in this house too. Many memories right here. Good slap boxing and barbecues right here. This is the old spot right here. I don't know who stay here no more. We ain't got time to knock on every door because we'll be here all day. This is the hood. I used to stay right here too. You feel me? This is my brother Drick. His girl's family from California stay right here. You know, they from Tulare and shit. You know, Northern California. So we been fucking with it. This is where it all goes. Check that out. So many memories from right here, man. Tears, man. Blood, sweat, and tears back here. Blood, sweat, and tears. Honest to God, man, right here, man. So much emotion, my man. So much emotion, bro. It was crazy. And this is where it all went down, man. Right here, this is where everything went down. We can't get in this motherfucker until we see somebody and they gonna let us in this bitch. Somebody gonna let us in this motherfucker. You hear that?
Dirty dugout, baby.
I-5, nice to meet you, brother.
Yeah.
Man,
I was
trying
to get out here.
You got
your video going.
This is where it all went down.
The gate wasn't so far. Yeah, man.
Like I said,
I remember them coming through here. Check this shit out, man. It go down in here, man. You feel me? And I used to call, you would claim your hallway. You feel me? You would claim your hallway. This is like your driveway. Like, what are you doing in my hallway? Okay? Let me show you my hallway. Yeah, we about to take you there right here. We going to my spot right now. Everybody got a hallway in this business, what you control. You feel me? So this is all my hallway. You feel me? Cuddy up top. I'm right here, okay? You feel me? This is where This is where we shoot the dice and we have the meetings and all the shit. It's trappy back here, man. Shout out all my niggas. I ain't gotta say no. It was lovely back here. You can shoot your dice right here. You can get ran right here. Yes. All kinds
sleepy
of shit.
Time. Lullaby, nigga.
Yeah, I'm talking about.
Come on.
This is where we at. And whoever's up top, look out, man. You feel me? Take it through this motherfucker one time.
This is where it goes down, no, man. And they switched it up with the wall, too, because we used to have little holes right here.
You feel me?
You know what I'm saying?
This shit was
for real.
Okay.
You know, we used to stick the cannons out or, you know, wherever else we had to do whatever is necessary to survive, man. You know, different lookout points, breach points.
Breach points.
Exit strategies.
Exit
you know
strategies.
What I'm saying? To get up out of here, man. You know, the nappy dugout.
This was it right here. Take a look at that, good. You don't want your face to be in that. Mm-mm. Only feet on that. Only feet on that. No face on that. It's
and like he said, we had sections.
You would never see no shit like this. I mean, this is a classy upgrade. Take a look at that. It's just sitting here. This is not a prop. We did not put this here.
Come on.
You feel me? Take you on up. This way you can see everything. Check out this view. Isn't this a beautiful view of the city? It was nothing but cousins. See, you wouldn't know it. See, that's what you think. You think, oh, jug infested. Nah, nigga. It's little cousins all over it. Families is here. These is families. Families. You feel me? So when I talk about shit I be talking about this morning with the Kingway X and mixtape, just know that I'm talking about families off of this joint. It was a family feel all through here.
Absolutely.
You feel me? I'm gonna take you back down to my crib in a minute, just give you a little tour. Gutter.
Wow,
right over here,
wow,
man.
It's been a long time.
In the nappy dugout, we call the Austin's, man.
The Austin's, cuz. Remember this shit? Smacking through this motherfucker. This shit we have once again on any enemy. We got the drop on from up here. Check this view out. He's got. We done seen him from a mile away, really. Got niggas right here watching over there. You feel me? Down there, you go down. Everybody see. Around like 30 motherfuckers in one little area, you feel me? All you hear is hella loud, just hella talking, you feel me? And you smell hella chronic smoke.
Come on.
And he would yell from up here if he need anything or I need anything, you know, cuz we're always there. Sugar, whatever.
Yeah,
got some sugar down there? Yeah, you got some butter up there?
Yeah, you know? Look over there to my apartments over there, you know what I'm saying? The law was so tight on us, man, we had hand signals. That we used to, you know, piss you a nigga. You know what I'm saying? Whatever he needed, you know, case would be. You know, we had hand signals. You know, fast pitch. You know what I'm saying? Out there playing catcher and giving the pitcher the sign, like, yeah. Come tax that ass, man, you know what I'm saying? So niggas ran real orchestrated.
Okay. Believe that, we different, we really was, man. We'll take you to my spot.
And also, peep this railing right here. This is how we used to hit this roof, man. We climb right here and hit this roof, man. You know what I'm saying? And be, you know, watching the whole shit, man. Before niggas do with this shit, man, you know, real niggas start off at lookouts for the big homies.
That's right.
Scouting shit, scout report, draft report, all that, man, you know.
So you had hella scouts on deck everywhere at all times.
Yes, sir. Boy scouts and black scouts, nigga. It's just a different area. Boy scouts in the jungle, black scouts in the concrete jungle.
Mm-hmm. I ain't been up here in a long time.
Come on.
God, we moved so far away from here.
I know,
huh? It's crazy coming back home to see it. It's like, you know, they upgraded with hardwood floors. There's not no more concrete. You don't see the drug addicts in the hallway. Nothing.
You see how they do that? So why do you think that is? That's what I'm saying. That's what this shit is about. That's what this documentary is about. Why do you think that is? They make that shit look like that. They put a Whole Foods at places like Columbia Plaza. They tore down Zion Preparatory Academy. Y'all talking schools. They cleaning up apartments. Like, we smart in the hood, so we know what that is. We know what that means.
They wanted to be nice when they wanted to be nice for who they wanted to be nice for. Not for everybody, though. It's not an everybody thing, you know?
No, it's not. It's definitely not. Because if it was, it would be evident. We would be living in that reality, but we're not.
Right.
Straight up. We about to go down here and check out my old spot. This is where I live. This is my hallway. Me and my brother Drick, man. Free Drick. My brother had Holly. My brother Drick. Gravy to try to get up in there. I'm gonna tell them who I am and I'm gonna see if it's appropriate. And if they gonna let me in, then I'm gonna show you where I slept at. You feel me?
Come on.
Let's see if it still opens.
They're just
pinning it
to the floor
We're gonna see what's in.
Can you see that one still open? Does it still open? This one right here is sealed to the floor. It doesn't come up. You know, like, you know.
Exactly.
How we used to do that, man, you know.
Exactly.
We used to put
exactly.
it in.
Exactly. Exactly.
I want you to leave that for your mind to wonder.
Yeah. Well, they ain't answering the door right now, but this is where 106, man. This motherfucker right here was going damn. That's my apartment. Me and my brother Drake and the Cali family. We brought the Cali and the Seattle family together, man. In many different roofs. The one I showed you over there, the one I showed you over here.
Yeah.
All over, man. You feel me? So we've been connected on this West Coast shit. And I'm going to tell you one thing for sure, two things for certain. It's family first. That family shit. You feel me? Fuck that other shit, man. That's not what it's about. Through all the shit I'm telling you right now, we stay family. How is it that we maintain our loyalty, respect, and honor for ourselves to be able to do this? And I come back, we come right back to our shit.
It's always been culture and family. Culture and family.
Culture and family.
Consistent.
And a man is a protector and a provider. A woman is a queen and an educator. Feel me? She ain't educated, she ain't laced up, and she can't stay down, period.
Shit, what you were saying though is how would you say that shit? Where did this shit just go bad and all fucked up? Well, we ain't teaching this, you know, we ain't teaching the family values no more. We're not talking about community anymore now.
I'm gonna tell you why, man. The reason you're not talking family values is because everybody is talking about something contrary to what they're living. If you're not living in that, we're not all together no more. You feel me? We're all split up. And how does that split up happen? See, we're just studying the effect and not the cause. You see what I'm saying? You need to study cause and effect to understand South and Seattle. This is big, man. San Francisco's going through it too. Gentrification. They're taking neighborhoods. They're splitting us up. So that's why people lost their sense of talking about family values, cultural, that the shit that we preaching. This loyalty, this life, you know what I mean? For these youngsters,
right.
You feel me? They can't understand that because we're not together. We're a collective consciousness. We can't do it without being together. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's why the, you know, opposition's main objective is divide and conquer. Get them motherfuckers split out. You feel me?
Come on.
Take over.
You're not as strong when you won. And you talking about destructive shit. We constructive, we build. I mean, come on, we came from out of this shit, man. Are you fucking kidding me? You know how many times my life was at risk? Not to mention my freedom, nigga. Fuck you, man. My house is the spot. You feel me?
Yo, I hated the stairwell, okay?
Did you?
Nigga, I used to come down. There'd be niggas in the hallway. I'm like, excuse me, can I get out, please?
Oh, yeah.
Burnt, sitting on the stairway. Like, nasty.
This is nasty. All right. You know, bust that beat one time. Cut it off. You better beat that thing one time, man. Let me bust a freestyle while you keep banging one from you off the thing one time, cuz.
I can just
grab
my phone and play your instrument. That's how we do.
Yeah.
We just pull out random instrumentals.
Yeah. I'm gonna bust the freestyle, man, for the camera, man.
You know,
that's
the freestyle. What time
for? Yeah. Living in the Austin. Shit might cost them. Everywhere I go, I'm looking for niggas who be flossing. Not because I like their clothes. I'm trying to strip him out of shit, even if the nigga gotta catch some hoes. That's how I was raised. With the foes and trash, in the days of the Austins and the Fontanelles, in the days of the weeds and the pills and scales.
Hey, near man,
You know, you'll make it whoppy, man, and get a ticket from you all in the same day. Fucking around with this Ranier life, man, with these grooves was rocking around here, man, you know. When the South End was popping before they kicked us up out of here, man, you know. They tried to kick us up out of here, man, and take over the city, man, but it takes real niggas to start up small businesses and keep revenue flowing through the hood, man. You gotta keep the black money flowing through the hood. You know what I'm saying? That's what, man, a bunch of us been on, man. You know what I'm saying? Fuck catching the body, let's catch the business.
Yep.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
You know, nothing against my niggas, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, too many niggas is out here just taking hands off and all that. And we need to put a book in these niggas' hands and educate the niggas so we can survive, man, so we can last.
Get smarter.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta everlast the game. You gotta study it, but you gotta be better than the game. Because the game will eat you up if you don't know what you're talking about, man. Yeah, this is Ranier Avenue, man, right here, man. I see the bunch of shit go down over here, man. You know, I'm gonna just leave it at that, man. I ain't gonna say no names or nothing, man. You know, but memorials all around here, man. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy, man. Where we came from, you know, to see what it is now. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy.
Years later. Welcome to the Fontanelles. I'm gonna bring you through this motherfucker. This is my old stomping grounds. We used to live up here. Me and my brother Trick Love and his bitch. You feel me? Take you under. Man, I got hella memories right here, man. So much shit I done in these hallways.
Here is them raindrops. All I hear is them same shots. Much respect when my name drops in the conversation with your main boss. Riding around with them chainsaws. 30 rounds of that pain cross.
You feel me? This is where we stayed at right here. So I could see everybody who was out here, you feel me? I had good access point once again. As you can see, this is where my old house was. Me and my brother Drick Lope. We was here for a cool minute, you feel me? This is it, this is where it all went down. Fontanelle. This is the infamous Othello block. I'm gonna take you to my old apartments right here. This is where me and my brother Drake come from Holly. We'll be up in here and this is where we did our thing. Steps, man, this is where it was all at. This is where we experienced all of our dice games right here, you feel me? Me and my brother was slap boxing, get into it right here. He be telling me don't bring females to the house, but you know, little brother don't listen. This was where it all went down right here, feel me? This was our spot, me and my brother Drake from Holly, and we was in here, man, and it was lovely. It was a family environment, so as you can see, we was all over here. We're really from here. A lot of motherfuckers act like they from here, but they really not. You feel me? We're really from here. We love this place, bro.
Got any memories of this place?
Oh, man.
Small ones, little small one.
I remember one time, my brother was drunk as fuck, tripped down these goddamn steps. You feel me? Niggas tried to tell him he was drunk and he tried to fight all of us.
So how do you feel about individuals who you never seen before in your whole life through the streets of Seattle? Who have a lack of study, which have a negative influence, is that the correct term that I'm using, for the youth of Seattle?
Yeah. I understand what you're saying. People who's manipulating these youngsters because they have lack of study they self.
Righteous.
They didn't learn from the ones who became before them. But first off, I gotta say, if I never seen you in Seattle and you never seen me, man, I don't know how. I don't know how. I grew up on all sides from South City to West. I went to all schools. Got kicked out of school back to back. You name it, High Point, Madrona Middle School, Franklin High School, all different sides, it don't matter. So if I ain't see you in Seattle, maybe you was just less of an outside person, you feel me? Or maybe you wasn't really fucking out here. Regardless, whether you was out here or you're not out here, you gotta have something to provide for the next generation. Especially you being older, supposed to be wise. You feel me? They supposed to inherit that wisdom through what you give them. If you have lack of study yourself, you ain't got shit to give them. So I think y'all need are the ones who need to just basically keep your shit quiet and stay the fuck out the way. Don't express too much to these youngsters about what you feel and what you think, because you're gonna manipulate them through the way that you've been manipulated, through the society that's been dictated that we live in, products of our environment, shit. You know what I'm saying? So, if you lack studies, and I never seen your ass out here, it's one thing if I seen you out here and you lack studies, because I know what you're suffering from. Your mama was on dope, gang banging, I can understand that. You might have not gained the knowledge yet, or wisened up enough to know what you need to study in order to be able to give these youngsters something. Cause it's definitely a negative influence, everything you teaching these motherfuckers. Whose little cousins you think these is? Whose nephews, nieces, all these little ones. They gonna be slaughtered in the streets, on dope, hella babies they can't take care of, all the shit because you didn't give them the game, the real game, you feel me? That's what I think.
Now when you say outside peoples, or outsiders, can you define that a little bit more?
Well, shit, as far as which part of the question?
As far as those that you haven't really seen around in Seattle, or claim they're from Seattle, but you hardly see them around.
I'm gonna tell you just like it's saying my mixtape. You one of them niggas I never see in Seattle. I be studying the general's legacy in the battle like Napoleon. You feel me? And that pretty much sums it all up, man. I never seen you motherfuckers in Seattle. So don't get on, try to take a pedestal or get on the podium to try to speak to the youth or influence the youth in any type of negative way. You feel me? Because if you a smart nigga, you been in these fucking shootouts and these trap houses and shit. You know this ain't no fucking way for them to grow the fuck up. Have you ever had your house raided? Been shot the fuck up? Shot at? Shot some motherfuckers up? Well, that's what you motherfuckers need to think about these youngsters that's finna go through. That ain't no positive shit. That ain't no limelight. That ain't nothing to brag about. You feel me? That ain't no stripes, period. I said it, I-5.
So I-5, what do you think about Othello?
Shit, this the hood. I love Othello, man. I'm gonna tell you one thing I love about Othello. Othello Park, the Safeway always been here, and shit. There ain't too much more to say, man. As far as Othello, Holly Park right there, we always been cool with the Africans, but this is the same type of cultural feel you get down there in Columbia City. This is the same type of cultural feel you get in Henderson. You know, sure, everybody around Othello's always been broke, but that's never changed the way that their heart and their mind sees clear. You know, we got a lot of drug fiends around here. We have more respect for others than a businessman, than a European businessman who may be traveling the light rail every day. And this is real shit. You don't see it, but I do. So, when it comes to Othello Street and the Othello District, man, I done lived up and down Othello, man. It's like a very memorable place for me, you know what I mean? But basically what I'm saying is, Othello is one of the hearts of the city. This is one of the streets that's the heart of the city, you feel me?
Why so?
Because it's in between Henderson and it's in between Columbia City. It's a middle point between Columbia City and motherfucking Henderson.
Okay.
So everybody on the Henderson and Holly side comes to meet in the middle with everybody from the Columbia City side right here on Othello. Othello's the middle of the South and it's the central point.
Okay.
You feel me? I consider the South end Silver Fork. That's the South end. Going towards all the way to motherfucking Skyway, you feel me? But really Henderson clockwise, you feel me? So that's the middle point. Othello's always been a place where everybody from both sides come and meet up. You know what I mean? Notorious Othello, man, I love this shit.
Man, so tell me a little bit more about,
for your safety.
You know, small story. Give me a small story of what might have happened. Something you can talk about.
Man, let me see, right here on Othello. Hella shit, man. We got so many memories on Othello. I'm just trying to tell you one that don't incriminate myself. I swear to God, I love Othello, man. We do everything on Othello, from parking all our cars, slapping out that bitch. I'm telling you, Othello that shit. Othello was like a meetup point. Trapping, yeah, and no, depending on when, because you know Othello be hot, because it's one of the streets that's right in between Martin Luther King and Rainier. So they know that everybody's traveling back and forth, you feel me?
Okay.
All the way from Honest Jack's all up to right here, you feel me?
Okay.
The new Othello, I'm not feeling it. I'll tell you that right off top.
Yeah, why
not? I'm not feeling these condos right here that they fucking built with these fucking Europeans who walk around and don't acknowledge anybody else but themselves. Just real, real, real egotistical peoples. And they have no memories connected to this area, but they feel entitled to be a certain way. You see what I'm saying? If you ask them anything about this area, they can't tell you nothing about it. You know who runs Othello District? Europeans do. There's only 3 black-owned businesses on Martin Luther King.
Was it like that before?
It was never like that. But they trained the subconscious mind, basically, to try to get everybody incorporated into the system of what you might call, what they calling it, integration.
Ah, okay. That,
you know what I'm saying? Integration,
suspicious
man.
Ass word, huh?
Hey, man, I'll tell you right now, man. Apples and oranges, man. Apples and oranges. They may both be fruits, but totally different, man. You know what I'm saying? And at the end of the day, man, all this condos and all this shit they built, nobody can afford that fucking shit. Come on, man. How you gonna put that in a low-income housing area? Then you bring these richer Europeans around here who are always scared, always nosy, they always doing weird shit. You know what I mean?
Righteous.
Always.
Righteous.
You can have a camera on anything you're doing, man. The Europeans is watching and looking to call the police because they're scared. They don't know the type of black person you should fear or the type of black person you should embrace. They don't know the difference because they ain't grow up around black people. They watch them on TV. Yeah, you may have a couple on your sports team, but that's different than going to the family houses and experiencing what we actually do as a people in our neighborhood. You know what I mean?
Righteous.
Yeah.
Man, so tell me a little bit about the old Othello then, man. Let me know what it's like before then, before all this other shit started happening.
The old Othello was everybody met up together. Everybody was congregating for barbecues, for everybody's birthday party. It was like we were our own tribe. Whether you was from Henderson, Holly, Othello, wherever you was from that side or this side, everybody met up on Othello, man. This is where you congregate at. Everybody know that.
I feel you. Well, shit. Let's lead the youngins with a little jewel as to what they don't know about Othello, and then let's wrap this on up.
What you don't know about Othello is that they had real community revolution in progress.
Okay.
There was a real change going on right here on Othello. It was a consciousness change. So it didn't manifest physically yet, but it was happening. We were consolidating, feel me? As a collective conscious of black peoples, man, and Samoan peoples, and Asian peoples, and Filipino peoples, and Latino peoples, you feel me? We were consolidating, man, based on living next to each other. Then once you move the European in to integrate, they're trying to pretty much introduce a normality of Europeans and us together when that's not normal. I understand we are Martin Luther King white. I understand what Martin Luther King pushed. You feel me? I understand what he pushed. I understand the agenda that he was pushing. But what we didn't understand was ourselves and how we're gonna blend with somebody else when we can't even get access to the type of literature that's gonna tell us about ourselves. Black history is just a 1/1,000,000th of our history. You feel me?
Right.
So the new Othello, man, if you're a youngster, man, tell them to put all books right here on Othello. Put some bookstores up on Othello. Put some apprenticeships up on Othello where a person can learn a craft and get paid at the same time and be a positive contribution to our society in the South End. You see what I'm saying?
Instead of opportunity
on Othello, because it's access, it's easy. It's right here, right?
Yeah.
It's right here. That's what they should have done back when we had it, but they didn't. They might try to do it now because it's a different community on Othello. It's still black people, but not as many.
And you would say it's a little different. They're trying to the ones that they do want to integrate into this, they're not on the same consciousness.
Yeah, they're not on the same consciousness because you don't share the prior struggle to that. Life never is just is. It's not just what you see, the cars, the light rail systems. You don't see the things that happened before then. There's cause and effect. Just like you don't see the neighborhood before this, which is what this documentary is about, you don't see who we were as a people before Europeans were ever integrated with us. You can't even fathom that. You would think that we were primate people. You would think that we were more violent people. But, but it was actually
righteous. The other way around, it was nowhere like that. Nowhere like that at all. I feel you, my brother. All right, I'm gonna wrap this on up then, bro. Get a nice good sign of this Othello. Give a good shout out.
It's 206, man. We in the South and on Othello, man. This is the heart of the city, man. The black people's land, you feel me? All of us, the colored peoples, man. Shout out my Osas, shout out my Asians, my Filipinos, my Tongans, all melanated peoples, man. Fight for Othello, fight for Othello. Do not let them gentrify this area.
Right.
Well, Shannon, we right here back on the block on Holly. I'm finna take you to my Uncle Keith's house right here, man. I got 100,000 memories in this motherfucker. My cousin Tar, my cousin Sean. You feel me? Free Big S Low, you feel me? Free my big cousin, man. I love you to death, cuz of.
Get away for this, man.
This house right here, anybody who know anything, my nigga, anybody who's from Holly know about this motherfucking house. Period. Period. Or you ain't from motherfucking Holly. Period. So many memories. Rest in peace, Uncle Keith. Straight up. You feel me? This is where it all went down, man.
Look, they even fixed it up.
Try to at least. You feel me? It's all cracking right here, man. Every fucking day. Every day, man, we are all congregate right here. This is another family house. You feel me? These are the sacred memories to me that nobody know about. You feel me? Unless you was around me, period. That's right. So I'm bringing you to my cousin's house. This is the old house right here. We all used to go down with my big cousins, you feel me? And we just had a family feel, barbecuing, rapping, you feel me? Doing the things that we do, you know what I mean? It's the big cousin's house, man. Right here on 44th and Holly, man. I love him to death, man. This is all families connected, man. So when I tell you that it was a family feel, understand we were all around the corner from each other, man. It was always good till that shit hit. Take you to the alley where you can go from Holly. We on Holly right now, and Willow on the other side, man. You cut through the back of Brighton right here. This is an infamous alleyway. This take you right to where the basketball court was where you see me earlier, you feel
okay.
me?
Okay.
Yeah. And that's 4-4. You feel me? Don't forget.
So we're out here in Brighton, am I correct?
Brighton District, yeah, Holly. Yeah.
Okay, okay. So what's going down out here? What's the cultural feel out here? You know, we had a conversation off camera talking about, you know, where a lot of the cultural family feel is not, it's not put on camera, it's not put on, they don't talk about it, you know, they like that, throw it under the rug, or you gotta go through so much just to explain to people because they just don't get it.
Yeah, the reason they don't get it is because they wasn't a part of it. I mean, we used to have football games right here, man. It was going down, man. You don't understand family feel. Right here, you might just think of Holly and all the worst shit, but you don't never see the good shit, too. The good shit and the hood shit is connected. You can't mention one without mentioning the other, you know what I mean?
Right.
Huge football games here, all cousins, real cousins, all through here, man. Basketball, hooping, man. We hoop behind here, man. Let me show you, come on. Man, this is lovely, man. You know how many memories I got through here, man?
Shit.
Come on, cut the crap. Anybody who's watching this who's my cutty, all right? I'ma show you how to hop a fence out here in the South End, feel me? I'ma take you to where we used to hoop at, Family Field. Family Field, this was all Family Field. Everybody was around here was family. If you weren't family, we were like, who is you? You feel me? Who is you, really? Show you how to hop a fence. You know, I be shagging a little bit, but let me show you, man. Hopping fences is not just to run from the police because you have a sack of cocaine in your pocket. No, it's to run away to get away from being shot down also, because you can have nothing on you and still get blamed down. And that happens right here in Seattle. Watch. Okay, this is where we used to hoop at right here, and we were just chop game, man. You can look on this bench here and see about all this whole bench filled up with people. Feel me? Either waiting for a basketball game or chilling rolling a blunt or something. The whole thing, man. It's where we all hooked at, man. This is the family feel right here. Once again, man, South End of Seattle, man. This is the Brighton District, you feel me? Let me tell you where it really went down, man.
family feel back here, man. Everybody knew everybody, man. It didn't matter what you was doing, you know what I mean? It was all about the love and the unity back then.
I wanna know why.
You know, there's always been hatred and, you know, things that happen, I guess you could call them altercations in the neighborhood. But there's been altercations since the beginning of the time, you feel me? Especially when your society is dictated by someone other than you and your family. Well, we trying to dictate ours, man. This is our neighborhood, you feel me? This is our community that we're speaking for, you feel me? Our families and young generations who still go to these schools, who still are out here in the South and the Seattle.
Evelyn and
Chalice.
Oh!
Thank you. It looks like that we have cake over here, so please enjoy yourself. It has been a pleasure, Ms. Scott and I, to serve as your principals this school year. Thank you very much.
So I noticed that it's a really grimy feel. Has it always been like this?
It's always been a grimy feel because it's a grimy area, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
But there's always been a greater feel than grimy, if you will.
So talk about the greater feel, because I don't feel like a lot of people are gonna get this just because of the way that they set it up. I feel like they're trying to knock it down. They're trying to knock the cultural family feel down. So mm-hmm. Tell me more about that.
Yeah, they're trying to knock the cultural feeling down because it's in their best interest, basically. You feel me? A person is, you know, it's emotional on the half that we experience it, but on their half, they're just seeing it as a beneficial thing to divide and conquer us because they feel like we're a threat to them. Because if we learn self-sufficiency and we can just do our own shit, we don't need you for record labels, which they provide, for anything that they can provide for free, food stamps, whatever. You feel me?
And what about the good times, though?
Yeah. The good times is the hood times, man. They are right here, man. There's so many memories I can't even speak. My eyes speak volumes, you feel me? Millions and billions of memories right here where I'm standing, man, with all my little cousins, man. I'm a Columbia City baby, but man, right, Holly is right here, man. All my cousins, I'll be here every day. Every other day, if I was here, I'd be in Skyway. I'd be up and down Ranier Ave, Martin Luther King Way. I would visit your house at least once a day. Everybody know me, I'm sliding through the hood. That's what we do. We cutting through the hood. So this family feel was all about seeing the dude every day is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Seeing your families, seeing these families and knowing their progress and their struggles every day. Y'all don't know nothing about that.
You don't see it as much no more, would you say?
No.
Not at all?
No, definitely not. Because the community's changed and the community reflects how the people, you see what I'm saying?
So how can we bring that back?
I would say to bring it back, man, you gotta either start getting brothers to own banks or own homes, because we're talking property, we're not talking anything else. We're talking simply property, man. Property is probably what you spend most of your money on, nigga, in your life, nigga. These homes ain't no joke in Seattle. $1 million homes right here. The closer to the city, the more it costs. If we can learn to dominate on property, man, we'll win. That's some I-5's decision. If we come to the tables, I bring property up. That's the topic of conversation.
So what progress have you done already to bring that back? Because I know you've been working real hard in the past year, and I know that you've been trying to make this shit. You've been trying to bring a lot of change.
Yeah, most definitely. I'm trying to bring about the change because the change has proved that it's necessary, though. You know, cause and effect, you know what I mean? We didn't learn this by force. This ain't something that's been forced as far as trying to tell these youngsters to do something positive. Man, this is the real shit, you goddamn it.
Right.
It shouldn't have to be a thing like an optional thing. Like the next generation is the most substantial thing in our lives, man, straight up. Cause I was once that to my older cousins, man, you know what I mean? I was once that to the ones above me, you know what I mean? I was the progress, I was the future that they can see through the same face, with familiar face, you feel me?
Right.
You know, how you gonna have that happen when you don't have property, feel me? That means that you can be moved to any location at any time, wherever's cheapest. You feel me?
Sound like human trafficking to me.
Something like it. Real shit. Over here on South Hollywood, the cousins about to take you to another family house. This is one of the most infamous and one of the most beautiful family houses, man, where it all went down, you know. Making music, everything you can imagine right here, man. Nothing but 100 cousins probably ran through here, about 1,000. You know, We're a family thing, and this is a family function. This is my big cousin. You feel me?
What's happening? Mr. Sandman, Little Gene, 206, South Side of the Bricks.
Yeah, yeah.
Shit, been representing this shit for 40 years. Been up here all my life. This is the school we started. Writing. Didn't look like this coming up, though. This is a brand new school, man. They rebuilt this a couple years ago. with that good money. They got tired of that hood money, you know? Probably make some of that hood money with the good money, if you ask me, you know what I'm saying? But whatever. This whole little alleyway right here used to be open. All this was hoop. We had hoops right here. All this was open. It's all closed off now. This used to be the back of the school going now that way. Now it's the back of the school going this way.
They hit him with a 90-degree angle twist. This before my time though, you know, when I was just a tiny tiger, like my nigga Key said, you feel me?
Shit,
this
what?
This is my view. This is my view coming and going, heading home, heading to school. I used to see all this right here. See the kids running up and down here. We had tetherball poles up and down here. I rode my first bike up through here.
Damn.
So, going back to some old times, then let me ask, what does it mean to be a South Ender? You know, what's the culture like?
Man, you know, it's the South End, man. It's hard to explain other than to say, you know, a lot of us grew up knowing each other when we was breakdancing, doing graffiti, you know, different shit like that. You know what I'm saying? We had crews and shit, and we was all going from hood to hood. We was always on the bus, riding through, you know what I'm saying, meeting up. So we was always like a family, you know what I'm saying, with the exception of once, you know what I'm saying, we start getting the crews together, cats start beefing over the, you know, over the spots and the who got what, and you know what I mean, back in the days of the jacking and shit like that. Somebody you might have known for, you know, the first 10 years of your life, man. Run into him when you're 15, man. He might run up on you and try to take your shoes, you know what I'm saying?
So before all that happened, what was it like? What was a family like?
Man, you know, we had the parks, Othello Park, Sewell Park. We could ride bikes up through there. Wasn't no problems, man. You know what I'm saying? It was, you know, we was kids though. You know, you talking about the 80s. The late 70s for me and the early 80s, you know what I'm saying? We could do shit like that, ride wherever we wanted to go, walk down the Ranier, and you know what I'm saying, just foot it all the way where we need to go, man. Well, no problems.
You hear that? We were foot it everywhere we went, you feel me? Foot it.
Yeah, we used to walk.
Bus it, 7, we 42.
We would walk at night. We would walk in the middle of this block, yelling, doing anything we wanted to do, straight up and down this block. See, that tree wasn't in there. It's just big ass tree. No, that's great.
So what?
Did they move that motherfucker?
I get the tree.
Did you see that big ass tree?
That motherfucker's fat.
Like they put a big ass tree there and chopped all this down.
Right. That's exactly what they did. That's this is crazy. That is exactly what they did. They shot that.
This is where you used to go. This is where you used to come around this corner and see. Let's see what he about to do. Yeah. You do that right there. Police come around the corner real quick. Snatch you up because that used to be illegal. And they used to sit right here in front of my house, sit in front of Cuz Marvin and Nudie, them guys in house over here. There. Next thing you know, somebody come around this corner, you hear the police right around. Boom. Catch him right here. Cats got older, we used to travel. Motherfucker, can't get pulled over, gotta leave his car, gotta walk away with them boys, man. His car be sitting on the block for too long. I don't know, you know what I'm saying?
You come back, that car won't be there.
Yeah, it might not be there, man. It might be missing all four of them good ones. Yeah. Yeah, man, this is the house I grew up. You see that address right there in the mailbox? They make it look good. That 4414 look real good on that mailbox. Yeah.
There's at least that many memories.
This is where I grew up at, man. We built that front porch, we built that side porch, put that siding on, man, as you know what I'm saying, coming up. That's what we learned how to do in, you know, in my 20s. Me and my little brother had the house, took care of it for as long as we could, man, you know what I'm saying? But shit changes, cats grow up. You gotta move on. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But it's always family over here, man. I had big parties. I let my homeboys do their record release off my front porch. We had barbecue all in the yard for cats. All of this was packed. Police came through, stopped for a second, looked at everybody. We had every set out, every hood I could think of, all up in here, man. I'm talking about cats that maybe 3 weeks later, they was beefing again. But right here on that day, my guy Section 8, they got off, man. They got off, man. Shout out to Section 8, you know what I'm saying? My cousin Keontae Bankhead, these people, man.
Yeah.
Young chicken cats, man.
Yeah.
They got off over here, man. So this is what it was, and this is where we did our stuff at. As we got a little older. But you know, it's like every other South End in any city in America. You're gonna hear sirens, you're gonna see lights. The lights go down in the sky, the lights turn on the boys' hoods. That's all there is to it. It ain't nothing special, man.
So,
yeah, I had boxing matches out here. We had all kinds of shit to keep the family together, man. It was cool.
What you see here is another family house, like I told you, man. It was all good. It don't matter what hood you was from. When you was around cuz, it was family. Some motherfuckers don't understand that shit. Period.
Yeah, we had the J's. The J's down the street. Shout out to the Jeffersons, man. Everybody know the J's.
You already know.
Had them down the street, man. All you had to do was walk out my house, walk out to about right here and be like, I'm in! It's on.
It's on.
It's on. They either coming up here or we going down there to see what's cracking, man. And that's where we got down, man. Right down there in that driveway. I used to open that door. I had a pool table down there. Matter of fact, you know, DMS, you know, D-Shot had a compilation called Boss Ballin'. We put a cutout called Hoes Be Trippin'. We talked about the pool table. That was in that house, in that basement right there, man. We was all doing our thing, man. Mo and them guys was some cats from the South End that I grew up with. Shit, Mo from what? East St. Louis, I think, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, that's my family right there too, DMS. Shout out to DMS as well, you know what I'm saying? It was my people. And we launched record release parties for them from here. I'm saying, man, we grew up a lot of young cats right here in this house, man. We grew up a lot of young cats that rock in the city still today. Some ain't here, you know what I'm saying? Rest in peace, Young Bookie, Lil Spoon.
Rest in peace,
you know what I'm saying? But yeah. I got no idea who stay here no more, man.
So we'll say a lot of shit changed. How did this shit happen?
Well, slowly but surely, man, as you can see, in this city, they ain't gonna allow there to be no ghetto. There ain't no way around that. We can see it. Now, mind you, the houses ain't never been run down. You know what I'm saying? There's been some houses that may be mistreated, i.e. that one next to where I used to live. You see it, you can't even see it. But other than that, man, you know, this neighborhood itself has always been kind of kept up. You know what I'm saying? Cats always took care of themselves, took care of their families over here.
Speaking of family and culture, what's some culture from the South End that a lot of people don't know? It's just really you only know about it when you're actually here and experience it.
Well, man, you know, we got different groups as far as if you're talking about, depending on what type of culture you're talking about. Check out your boy, he's slinging ice cream, man. We good.
Yeah, you know that.
He ain't got no music.
He ain't even got no music. What kind of ice cream truck?
I don't know if he rolled up on us like he wanted some ice cream. Or if he was selling some ice cream. He ain't even got no music. But whatever. But anyway, yeah, this was the entrance right here to the back cave, man. If you knew it was up, we showed you the front. But then if you knew as well, you can come through here, hit that back alley. I don't know, down on either side of this barrier when you come through. If you come through and the walls is on the barrier, I tell you, stay to your right. You know what I'm saying? Dip back around, because you go right and go left, they're going to pull you over. You know, you're riding dirty, I can't help you. Right. So, you know, like I said, we hit this back alley and boom. So, yeah, the culture of the South End, man,
It was infamous.
I mean, it was exactly, you know what I'm saying? We mirror a lot of different cultures coming up. So when I was a youngster, we did the breaking just like, you know what I'm saying, like everybody else. We did the graffiti, have these garages that are white now, had graffiti. I remember that had graffiti on it. This didn't even have a fence here. But you know what I'm saying? We did the graffiti, we did the crashing and dashing, you know what I'm saying? These little corners right here. When this pole right here was the hide and go seek pole. Remember that, V?
Hell yeah.
Back when we were shorties, I mean, we was like, you know what I'm saying, 9, 10, 11, before moms would say you gotta be home when the street lights came on.
Yeah, no.
That was the pole right there. We'd all meet right here at this pole. My boy Mike Ken was right here. Dan. You know what I'm saying? V lived around the corner. I was here. Like I said, Marvin Nudy lived right there. We had Eric and Elliot right here, Cedric Curto up the street. Mike Sims over there. Mike Sims this way, Jeff and Steve Ivey over the hill, Michael and Marcus Wingo this way, Todd Brown over there, you know what I'm saying?
Lewis and Larry,
all these cats, man. And then, like I said, the Jays down the street, man. We get up right here, boop, that was the pole. You know what I'm saying? We play that until the street lights came on. Then when the street lights came on, the youngsters get out of here, we might keep playing a little bit longer, you know what I mean? Make it a little bit harder. They didn't move a couple of the families out. Now they rode through, you know what I'm saying? Like it's the fair through between Ranier and M.L.K.
Yeah.
They used to come through here. They used to go straight up Holly.
Now they walking dogs.
The cats used to go through Holly. Now they hitting corners around here.
Motherfuckers was walking dogs and shit.
Huh.
Yeah, you see nobody walking no dogs around this motherfucker.
But we got nice neighbors though.
Became real comfortable.
Yeah,
and they real sometimes, and it's crazy because a lot of times they try to make you feel motherfucking comfortable in your own shit.
Uncomfortable.
You feel me? Like how you gonna feel? We can never feel uncomfortable in something like we just as rooted as the grass is in this motherfucker. You feel me? So you can't really make us feel uncomfortable. We connected. We connected to this landmass. You feel me?
Hey, so I-5, what do you think about Facebook gangsters? The motherfuckers that's just posing pictures and trying to act hard on the internet.
Shit, when y'all get your ass incriminated for showing all them guns and all that shit that you trying to stunt to say that you are that person that motherfucking the street should already know that you are, that just puts you and your team in a position where the light is on you all now. They got the red light on y'all, you feel me? So they put that light on you, now you incriminate you and your team. You feel me? So that's not in the benefit of you, your hood, or your interest, whether it's your plug,
right,
whoever you fuck with.
This is some stupid shit.
You ain't gonna see I-5 on no videos with no motherfucking hammers. Cause niggas know how I move. You ain't gonna see I-5 with no packs and no pills or no cream or none of that shit. Cause niggas know how I move. You ain't gonna see I-5 doing none of that shit because niggas know how I move. So the harder you have to portray that shit, whether it's for visuals or to give people imagery, or I heard all the excuses, my nigga, your ass is booked because of that. So you need to weigh that shit out. Like real niggas do, measure it out. What am I showing? What are the risks? Because they have learned to pretty much treat young black men, especially the rappers, as an asset to the criminal justice system. Meaning that, anything you do, they're gonna capitalize and make money. So while you doing whatever you do for your interests, they have a side interest also. There's a third party in that motherfucker that you don't see, who has interest based on when you fuck up, when you slip up, and get caught with that pistol, showing that shit on. You feel me? So, you know, I said in my song, my nigga, I ain't never been no Facebook gangster. Niggas trying hella hard to make their face look gangster. Posing pictures, their apparel smoking, lead body stiff. It's frozen switches in Seattle, we riding on frozen six.
Say usually just keep it silent, right? Don't need to show off and stunt and do all this other dumb shit.
Yeah, guaranteed. Cause ain't no need to. If you have a desire or a temptation or some type of infatuation with showing motherfuckers who you are on camera,
doing the wrong thing.
Yeah. And that's nothing personal with me, but it's on you is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Your mama gonna have to send them motherfucking green dots and shit.
Yeah.
Or your mama gonna have to pay for whoever's your support system. Now I'm gonna have to come out they pocket. Cause jail costs. Nigga, if you busting spreads and you trying to eat, nigga, that shit costs. Them fees cost from them lawyers, my nigga. You talking to a nigga who been fighting cases my whole fucking life. Feel me?
feel me? So you really need to stay the fuck off the cameras to just sum the shit the fuck up, nigga. Quit trying to be too gangster on camera, nigga. Feel me? But the world know you a gangster. The world know you a gangster. You ain't gotta push no line like that, you feel me?
Right.
Period. I-5, nigga, from the mouth of my mouth, you feel me? Real shit. Don't get your ass incriminated. Don't get your ass booked over this dumb shit, nigga, because it ain't worth it, nigga. That's not in your best interest. You feel me? There's no amount of money that's worth the amount of time, you feel me, that they finna give you for that shit. Because you can't do nothing inside the books. Box. What you gonna do? Write books? Nigga? Beat your meat, nigga? You feel me? You can't travel, you can't get no pussy, nothing, nigga. It's a wrap. You feel me? So yeah, stay off them cameras with them bangers and them drugs and showing everybody who your niggas and all that shit, man. It's Seattle, nigga. I'ma set the motherfucking trend. The trend is show them what, it's a need to know basis, nigga. It's the South End, nigga. Keep them on a need to know basis. If you in Tacoma, whether you from the east side of the hill or Lakewood, nigga, need to know basis. If you from Portland, it don't matter where you at in Portland, northeast, nigga, need to know basis. Sacramento. Same thing, nigga. Whether you from Oak Park, whether you from South Sac, nigga, North Sac, nigga, you know what I'm saying? Keep them on a need-to-know basis, because they got a task force for that. Frisco, need-to-know basis. San Jose, L.A., Fresno, wherever the fuck you at, nigga, on the West Coast, or not on the West Coast, nigga. Keep these motherfuckers on a need-to-know basis, because you're an asset to the criminal justice system, nigga. Don't you dare forget it, nigga. Period.
Hell yeah, real spit. Mm-hmm. Shit.
Yeah, that's the truth.
So I-5, when you think about Sharpton's Park, what do you think of?
Man, I think of 39th Street. Welcome to 39th Street, my nigga. Sharpton's Park is the home of all meetings. It's the home of where all the black people was who stayed in between Martin Luther King and Ranier Avenue. You'd have to come straight down 39th Street. All my homies grew up right here, man. Rest in peace, Mickey. Rest in peace, a lot of motherfuckers people don't even know. You feel me? From the older era, you know what I mean? 39th Street is the spot though, man. This is where everything went down. This is the crack middle street. It's the only street that goes all the way through that you can cut from Martin Luther King to Rainier. It cuts all the way through. You can't take no other streets all the way through. You gotta come through 39th Street and you gotta come see I-5. Straight up. I'm gonna show you why you should live. I used to stay right around the corner. This is my hood. If you wanna know who I-5 is, all you gotta do is study Sharpton's Park. It's like me and Sharpton's Park is pretty much married. We've been married for a long, long time. I used to come and visit her every day. Me and all my partners would come visit her. Not everybody could fuck her though. You know what I mean? This park is beautiful. This okay. Park is where everybody congregates. All black people, Asians, Samoans, everybody in the South End community, everybody out here. So one thing about Sharpton's Park that you realize is that you see Africans, Somalis, Ethiopians, everybody's out here at Sharpton's Park. Sharpton's Park has always been a place where everybody can come to congregate, you know what I mean?
Right.
That's why I love it, man. It was right down the street. I used to walk here every day, man. I stayed on 39th South Brandon, so you know I just walked up the hill, right up here, man. And this is where I spent all my time, man, the majority of my time, man, as a youngster, you feel me?
Okay.
Right here in this park, man.
Okay.
39th Street forever, man, Sharpton's Park. I used to stay right here on this house, right here on the corner. Let me show you. Come on, check me out. I used to stay right here next to the Kingways. These are the Kingway apartments right here to the left. Check those out right there. You feel me? So all I had to do was walk from the house. You feel me? Let me show you something. And I've been here my whole life, man. Until I moved to California. This is where it all started, man. Right here in the Kingways and the K-Dubs, man. Nick, come take a walk with me. I'm gonna show you where my house at, man. This is my old house right here, man. I used to have to come out here and box with my brother every time I got in trouble, come back in with a busted lip. My sister be asking me what happened. Yeah, every time I got in a fight at school, I had to fight my brother. He like 7 years older than me. This is where it's at, 5810, man. You feel me? So many memories right here, man. We're gonna check it, turn the camera off real quick, see if they gonna let us actually come through and see what's inside the house. You feel me? But this is where it all started for me. You feel me? This was one of another spots I stayed on 39th Street, and I'm a 39th Street veteran. You feel me? Man, this is 39th Street in South Orcas. This is my partner used to stay right here. Everybody know Bull in the town, you know what I mean? Roger Logic, you feel me? Andrew right here, I used to come through here every day. By the time we got to 39th in Orcas, we had about four more kids and we would just keep pushing down 39th until we gathered enough kids to go do whatever we was gonna do. And we would all start from 39th in South Brandon from my block. It would come from the dead end, we would cut out, and we would come all the way up 39th Street, man. And we'd end up at Sharpless Park, man. You feel me? I'm gonna take you down to my block, 39th in South Brandon. Let's get it.
What do you think of when you think of Seattle, Washington?
Man, there's two sides of that question, to be real, my nigga. One side, man, I think of how it was blacks, Asians, and Samoans. We was all consolidated in the same neighborhood. And how we had a cultural feel. Like, it was cool. It was hood. You know, you had shit going down, you know what I mean? There was shootings, dope dealing, but that was all not dictated by us. That's just what we lived in, by products of our environment. But we make the best of it. So I feel like the better side of that question, man, to answer your question, man, is like, you had a sense of who you were and the circumstances you were in and who you were. Before social media and all that, you know what I'm saying? The other side of the question is like, man, you had to keep your hoodie on, man, in the 206. You had to hustle through this rain. So it's not like hustling any other place. We have to hustle in the rain. We get rain 9 months out the year, 10 months out the year. So it's not like hustling anywhere else. You gotta hustle in this fucking rain. It's fucking cold. Socks soaking. I'm talking about your motherfucking shoes, nigga, soak. You gotta stand on the bus stops, you feel me? Because the buses come by and splash your ass. You be freezing. Fucking around and catch pneumonia out this bitch. This is Seattle, 206. You feel me? So that's you know, it goes both ways, you know what I mean? Welcome to 39th in South Brandon. This is where I stomp my stomping ground since motherfucking knee high. I'm gonna take you through this bitch. This shit was lovely out here. So this right here, man, we used to have a little trail. And you would be able to go back and forth in the trail, but as you can see what happened to the trail, they made all bushes and everything. But we as kids would go from my house right here, you see right down there, where we were at earlier, I'd be able to come up and down. This is the only way you would be able to get on 39th in South Brandon, because it's a dead end at the end of the block. And we would come back and forth. This is my street, man. I could walk right down the Ranier when I need it. We all come down here and we just keep going all the way down to 39th and Hudson, man. I'm gonna take you to the apartments where I stay right there on 39th down there. But this is the block, man. And we about to take you in the back cut. This is the back of my house on 39th and South Brandon where everybody would meet up. We would cut straight through the back just to get to Ranier. So, yeah. My backyard was the cut to the Ranier scene. I'm playing for the Ranier green. My backyard was the cut to the Ranier scene. These trees, they know me, man. These trees, they know me. These people in these apartments, they don't. Here's my house right here, man. This brown one right here, man. We would cut through the back way, and we would come right out that motherfucker and come right to Rainier like this. We all meet up right here at my house, cut through the back way. You feel me? And hit Rainier.
That's right near. Now let me take you through this motherfucker.
And was it always this bushy?
Oh yeah, it was always bushy, but it wasn't this bushy.
Okay.
They built up all this shit right here, man. So, cause they don't want people coming through it. This is my partner Adrian house.
This one right here?
Yeah, man. His mom's Filipino and his dad is black. You feel me? So the Filipinos was around here. Mark my territory, man. Hit this bush, man. You know what I'm saying? See if we still have that connection real quick. You know what I mean? Excuse me just a second.
The literature turn to ash cause they burning all of the books. My signature turn to cash and regardless of how it looks, my destination is close and it's desperation the most that I've ever felt in my life. I'm praying down on my knees like I never knelt in my life. No one ever sheltered my life and I know what shelters is like. I was homeless half of my life, Tacoma's half of my life, Seattle's half of my life, and these battles half of my life. Ducking rollers cause they'll lock you up for more than half of your life.
Dang, then we pushing it.
Oh,
what's up with it, cuz? That's my cuz. Get the shoot a documentary and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, I know. Make sure you get what's this shit. What's up with it, cuz?
It's my cousin's skin, man.
Man.
It's my real
man.
Cousin.
The shadow took coming the soon. I be biting in the darkness like the shadow you believe is the one that came to hunt you from your past when you deceived. Everybody who was closest to you, really, they were supposed to do. If their instincts was only that much closer to you, they would have put the toaster to you. Watching bullets roasting through you. Jealousy lives in the heart of people that's the closest to you. You don't fuck with hosts, do you? You don't fuck with monsters, do you? Talking about the ones without no family that mean the most is when you understand what it means to have no motherfucking culture, do you? Freeze up when descendants of the Moors come in.
Right here on 39th Street, we had everybody. Marcus and Dante stay right here. You feel me? The twins stay right here. Bagel, Leonard, and their little brother stay right here. Man, I done fought everybody, but we was all family, man, right here, man. It's dead end. It's connected. That's 39. Right there. That's the spot. There used to be a little cut through where you could cut through and we would go back and forth. But it changed. You would be able to cut through. All this, all them. Right here. This is all new. Once gentrification happened, they built this up right here. Feel me? That wasn't there. Feel me? All this new shit. That wasn't there. It wasn't there. Back and forth. Feel me? It's crazy because you got to see a hella shit going down, you feel me? My niggas stay right here, you feel me? All this shit. This is the Williams family. I love these people to death, man. This is the Williams family, man. Shout out my boy Aaron right here. You know what I mean? Rest in peace. Rest in peace, Mr. Williams, you feel me? That was the watch out. He sit on the porch all day and watch his kids. Feel me? All through here, man. It's beautiful. This one here. None of this shit was here. None of it wasn't here. It wasn't around. None of this shit was here. On anything I love. They just built this shit. All this shit wasn't here. All this shit is new. Shit's new. That's all new. This is it. Come on in, man. Welcome to right here, man. That's where it all happens, yeah, right here, man. I got put on right here. Right here in the back. Bop, 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 bop. Nigga had to put him on. Bam, bam, bam. Three niggas. Get down right here. Feel me? 39-18. This was all went down. 39-18, man.
See that 3-9, man. 18, man. Self branding. Feel me? This where the shit went down. All the shit that I ever seen. Right here. Right here. I used to be able to look through this thing right here. See this? I'll look through here and I see whoever's out here. Shit was crazy out here, my nigga. I'm telling you. But I love this shit. I love this shit like nothing else. Feel me?
So when did you move in Seattle?
Yeah, I moved to Seattle back in, I want to say 1992 or 1993 when my mom and sister got killed in Portland. And I got sent up here to a foster home that ironically my auntie ran, my auntie ran, you know what I mean? I was in a foster home for a little while. And then when I turned like 5, 6, 7, I moved to 3918 South Brandon right here. And this is where it all happened, you know what I'm saying? This is the first time I seen a gun put in my face by the police and the feds raiding the house looking for my uncles. You know what I mean? This is where I got put on the set right here. Man, hella shit happened right here. I remember I was playing for Ranier Green, you know what I'm saying? For the Eagles, for those who don't know, you know what I'm saying? Columbia City babies, man, we right here, man. I was a Ranier Eagle, 1996, man. It was like 100 kids around here, all black. It was all black before gentrification. You know what I'm saying? It was a bunch of black kids. I could just go knock on door to door. Can Adrian come play? And can Twin come play? Can Marcus come play? And we just knock on the door. And by the time we round up everybody and go all the way up 39th, we have about a good 20, 30 people. We run football. We do whatever. We all fight. We fight each other guaranteed, but we all love each other, though. You feel me? And that's how it was back here, man. It was like a real cultural feel, you know what I'm saying? Even the raccoons was good around this motherfucker. They come get them a plate, you know what I'm saying? The squirrels, all that shit, just the south and the dead end. So we didn't have too much traffic. We knew who you was when you came in here. This was like, you come in here, there's only one way to escape. You have to go through the bridge, go through the bushes up to 39th Street, you know what I'm saying? That was the only way. And we'd see you coming down the bushes from right here. You know what I'm saying? So it was just so much love back then, and everything changed, you know what I'm saying? But I remember the first time they raided me and kicked this fucking dog. I was in my jammies, man. You know what I'm saying? It was crazy, man. So I moved here in 1993 to answer your question. Take you through the neighborhood right here, man. This is 39th and Pearl Street, man. I stayed in these apartments right here, me and my cousin Justin. Man, this is lovely down here too. It was all lovely, man. All cousins, all family. Let me take you through here. Look how they clean shit up after the brothers move out there. All the black people. Look how they clean it up.
So this didn't look nothing like this before?
Hell no. Where I stayed way down here, man, this shit was grimy as fuck. Now look at it, orange doors. They got numbers on there. Look at this, man. This is what they do, man.
They cleaned it all up once y'all left.
They got paved roads.
So none of this was here?
None of this shit was here, man. This shit was like a trash spot. You feel me? This is my door where I stayed on 39th Street. Right here. Now look at it. Plants. Look at that, man. We couldn't get no plants. How come we couldn't have no plants? How come we couldn't have nice doors? Ask yourself why. Why when black people live in the community is fucking terrorized? Why is it destructive? Why is it destructive? Why are the minds of the people destructive there? You feel me? They right. Don't do anything to show pride in the neighborhood.
Right.
Look at the shit that they built. They got gates, all kind of things. Look at this. We couldn't get no shit like this. And this is bullshit. I want to say fuck you, Seattle. Seattle Council, fuck you, man. Look at this shit, man. Look at this shit. They got fucking, look at it. see what happens. That's why I-5 is the way I-5 is. That's what makes I-5. I understand the things before you see the things that you see. You just see this as an apartment complex.
But it didn't look like this before at all.
Exactly. And it's crazy all the shit that I done seen growing up right here, man. We right behind the Esquire. This is where me and my uncle would go damn near every weekend. I used to, you know, do poetry and shit. He would get me up in there and I would speak my piece, man. I've always been able to speak, you know what I mean, what was on my mind. You feel me? My uncle did poetry too. We just came from his house on 3918 South Brandon. Well, he would bring me to the Esquire, this club right here. And that's where I-5 really learned to start speaking out. I was young, man, in the Esquire, doing poetry, doing spoken word, man. This is an infamous block, but it means a lot more to me than it means to most people, man. Understand that, man. This is where a lot of my shit started, right here on 39th and South Hudson. You feel me? 39th, though. You feel me? Don't y'all forget where y'all come from, because I never did. For real.
So I-5, what does this street mean to you right here?
Man, this street means, man, I used to stay with my sister right here, man. In this house, man, the Europeans done fixed it up real nice, you feel me? It was me and our two Rottweilers, me, my brother, both of my sisters, man. And this is just a memoir, or just a lovely area, man. We used to be able to cut through the bushes and go right there to Ranier Playfield. I just walked to Ranier Playfield, man, come walk back. Just within that small walk to Ranier Playfield and back, I would see hella shit, man. I'm telling you, I see so much shit, man. It was crazy how much you could see. Just walking back and forth to practice. But now they done fixed it all up, you know what I mean? Made it look nice to accommodate you know who. This is my old house right here, man. Look at it. Look how nice it is, man.
It's all fenced up. They had it fenced up like this before?
No.
Can't even see back there.
Nah, you know how Europeans are. They want to be isolated, man. They want to be private, you know what I mean? So nobody can see in there, so they can, that's where they do all their fucking dirt.
So what does I-5 think about Columbia City? How you like it?
Oh, man, I love Columbia City, man. Since Rainier Green, man, it's been the most loveliest experience for me. I swear to God it has, man. This is the most cultural feel you'll find in Seattle, man. From South Ends to Asians to Samoans. Man, this shit is all good around here, you feel me? I'm from 39th Street, but I play football right down on 38th, you feel me? You might have heard the term Trey 9, Trey 8, you know what I'm saying? That's Columbia City, you feel me? And this is the spot, man. This is where I grew up. I went to Zion Preparatory Academy right behind me, ZPA. For those who know, that's where all the badass kids went. We had to wear uniform and shit, you know what I'm saying? Free dress day was the shit. For those niggas who don't know, you feel me? ZPA was right here. But they tore that down once gentrification happened. But other than that, man, I love Columbia City. I done stayed up and down Martin Luther King. Man, on damn near every block. We out here in the hood. We live right here in the hood. We didn't bring no guns and drugs in this motherfucker. We was damn sure using them, you feel me? We not in control of that, so we made it out the worst circumstances. I think that's why Europeans look at us and they don't understand how we survive through all this shit, you feel
right,
me?
Okay.
South and all, at the end of the day, man, Columbia City, man, this is my motherfucking terrain. Fuck these crackers and fuck gentrification, straight up.
Shit, one last thing you wanna tell the kids out here in Columbia City that don't know what's really going on?
If I were to tell the kids anything, man, I'd tell them study yourself, man. Don't look at yourself through the image of the European, because the European has lost their self. Feel me? Learn to have a sense for your community, not as United States, but as your land. Whatever you want to call it, however you interpret your land and your experience on your land, you know, mold your mind and your mentality in the way that you're going to build your community based off of that, not based off of their shit, period. That's what I tell the youth for Seattle.
Righteous.
In your playfield right here where I was smashing all Vikings, CD Panthers, and everybody the fuck else. Three championships, boy. What y'all got to say? Ranier Green, man, Columbia City, man. Shout out Trey 8, Trey 9, and everybody from this motherfucking region, you feel me? South End. This was it. This is where the culture was at, man. Right here, everything went down right here, man. I used to have to run these fucking hills. Woo! It was a bitch. And this community center right here, this is the new one. Check this out, man. So many memories right here, it's fucking dumb. It's crazy. But let me show you where it all went down right here in the back, man. Slide up right here, man. This is where it all went down, man. Everybody would come out the gyms, man. They would come out this backside right here, man. Welcome to my side of the field, man. We over here at Ranier Community Center. And this is where I've been through all my shit, man. A lot of struggles, a lot of pains, but a lot of happiness too, man. I be at late night every motherfucking weekend. Every weekend, man. Niggas know me at late night. Niggas know me. My brothers, my cousins, we be down here thick, right here. You feel me? Shout out 206 Business, man. Columbia City, man. This is where it goes down. They don't know. I'm speaking from my side of the Vimy. I remember Rainier Community Center at the late night. 38th, 39th, nigga, try nah. Fuck what they talking about, we be right here. And all them other niggas, swear to God, they so square. My big brothers, big cousins took me to the shit. And everywhere a nigga go, I'm finna keep it lit. 206, nigga, to the fucking death of me. And I be whipping up South End recipes. Keep rolling. How about? And I remember we used to be out here like this though. Check game. Look, check out my, check it out. He calls. You feel me? They don't know about that original South Bend, man. Rainier Green, man. This is where it all went down for me, man. We was back in the day, man. We used to have the chance and all that shit, man. Rainier Green, man. Welcome to Rainier Playfield. This is the home of I-5. How are you? Man, we were so fucking deep. We had two squads, man. Rainier Green and Rainier White. You feel me? You know, I was first string, though. Niggas know. You feel me? But real shit, though. Rainier Green and Rainier White. We was hella deep. Hella deep back in the day, man. Now I heard they got all kind of new teams, man. That's why I need to stay more in tune, come back to Seattle a lot more, man. Never forget the culture, the football culture here in Seattle, man. Straight up. Nate Robinson came from up out them egos. Yeah, y'all know. A lot of niggas came up out them egos, man. You feel me? You know who it is. In a minute. Go.
Pushing through up in them white lacks, looking out for rats, rats and mouse traps. 206 and straps, packs and loud cats. The home of Starbucks, nigga, we got the loud packs. Sipping cognacs, listening for them phone taps. These cell phones tripping, I'm dipping behind the stove fast.
Everybody know this South End spot, man. You come out here, sell anything you need right here. This is the spot, you feel me? Been here since I was knee high. And this is the other side of Martin Luther King. It ain't the South End, but it's still Martin Luther King. And that's why I had to get in the documentary, man. Many, 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 many memories right here, man. Man, this is where everybody would meet after Franklin High School, man. This shit was cracking. Everybody know back here. I'm finna run up in here, grab something to quench my thirst real quick, you know what I mean? Real South Enders always stay thirsty, you know what I'm saying? Stay hungry. This is the spot right here, man. This is where we all meet up at Franklin and be posted right here. We're posted right here. You feel me? Passing the blunt, you know what I'm saying? Trying not to get seen by the teachers over there. This shit was crazy. Right here, man. So many memories, bro. This was the spot. You feel me? Here with my niggas from Gun Dealing Entertainment. It's the Cutting Nudy right here. OG Nudy. OG Nudy. You feel me? Out here moving. You know? Give them an introduction. Let them know where you at on the city.
Okay, we run the map on this West Coast, man. You know, Roof Gang, Holly Block, all that shit. We have our differences, but we still run all this, man. You know how this shit goes. Gun Dealer Entertainment.
You feel me?
What's happening? It's Big Bullet Low, South End, 74 Hoover Gang. Holly, all the good shit, you know what I'm saying? Everybody's well connected, out here getting money, you know, running around, dodging suckers, you know, doing what we do on a regular basis. You know, Don Dill Entertainment, we'll be in the city near you. Holly.
So as you can see, these are all family connections. Everybody's all connected. There's nobody who we didn't know. That was the old black South Seattle before gentrification, man. Now we see a bunch of motherfuckers we barely even know. You feel me? So this is the real Seattle. We're giving it to you live, for real. South End. Take y'all to the world famous Philly Steaks, you feel me? It was originally in the Central District off of Union. For those who don't know, but they move right here to Martin Luther King, Ranier.
So what happened at Philly's? What's going on with that?
Man, the owner got killed on First Street, man. Rest in peace him. So when he got killed, I don't know who took ownership, but all I know is Philly's moved to the South End, and it was a Central District landmark. Everybody know Philly Steaks. Philly Steaks, you feel me? Just like Ezell's. That was a Central District landmark, but it moved to the South End. So as you see, they want to come get some of the South End money, you feel me?
Righteous.
Brand spanking new. That Philly Steaks was originally a Central District establishment, but it came out South because, you know, they want some of the South End money. They ain't mad at it. Rest in peace to the owner. He got killed on First Street. It's been a minute, man, but I remember that shit like yesterday, man. And this is where it all goes down. Ranier and Martin Luther King actually connects. These are the two main streets for the South End, man.
I got out of state tags. I got hella white bags, white bags. So what you risking? Cause I risk it all. Cause what you niggas be missing, I ain't gon' miss it all. I'm like a crystal ball, I can tell your future, nigga. About 100 niggas right now, I can tell to shoot you, nigga. It's some slacks with a blazer, that's how they suit you, nigga. With a tie and some dark shades, looking Gucci, nigga. They at your funeral with Sadie, died for Gucci, nigga. Took some fatal shots from the Uzi, cause it was Boosie, nigga. Boosie, nigga. It's still Twomp 6 business, and we just split a bowl of noodles with the chopsticks, business. All my projects with us, all my project chemists, High Point, Holly Park, and the Lakeshore Village. Can't forget
the Martin Luther King and Rainier. This is Franklin High School. For those who didn't know, I-5 is a Quaker, man, you feel me? It's all green with me. Yeah, this is the gym right here in Franklin, man. This is where I spent all my hooping days, you know what I mean? A lot of good people come up out of Franklin, as you know. A lot of niggas didn't know I-5 is a Quaker, though, nigga, you feel me? Like I told you, all Columbia City babies, we come right here. From Rainier Green to Franklin, you feel me? Shout out my cousins, though. Vikings, you know, I fuck with Holly. This is where the shit went down, man. I'm talking about back in 2000, 2001, 2002, 2003, 2004, 2005, 2006, man. This shit was going down in this motherfucker, man. Welcome to Franklin High School. And we used to run this motherfucking shit. Man, we used to sit right here, my nigga. Man, be so many motherfucking bitches up here. It's crazy, man. Franklin was one of them schools. It was called the fashion show. You had to be geared up. If you didn't have no gear at Franklin, it was over for you. Done. What's up, boss man?
What's happening with you, man?
Man, you look like the same one from a long time ago. What's your name?
CJ.
CJ? You a coach, yeah?
Yeah.
From how long ago? Yeah, man, I knew your face. I used to play right here, man. CJ, nice to meet you again. My real name's Miguel. I'm a rapper now.
You think?
Yeah.
You here now?
Yeah, I'm coming
home.
I'm just coming home from California.
You think? Yeah. I don't need no disrespect.
For sure.
That's the thing, roll.
Yeah, man.
I'm taking them to my old school in California, don't know nothing about this, so I gotta show them, man. This Panther High School, man, we put out some of the best, Aaron Brooks and so on, you know what I mean? This is
dope seats, man. You go see them.
Yeah, let me take you something, man. It's been so long since I've been in here.
So you got Corey.
Oh, yeah.
AB, and you got some more up on this side, you got some more up there.
Is it open for there?
I can get it, bro.
Thank you, man. I'm gonna show you all the legends who come up out of Franklin, man.
Alright.
This was it. This is where it all started for me, man. Come on, bro. See that sign, Quakers, man. You know what I'm saying? That mean we waxed it up. You feel me? Quakers. These are legends right here, man. Franklin don't own, we don't only put out rappers, man. We put out some of the best, man. You see it right there, man. We don't just put out rappers, we put out hoop stars, you feel me? Look up there, man. Get those suit. Boy, feel me? I know all them other schools gonna be hollering all that shit, you feel me? Garfield, Rainier Beach, Chief Self, y'all with the Chief Self too. But I always was a Quaker though, you feel me?
Straight up.
I love this school, man. Yeah, man. So now you know where I-5 is, you feel me? This is home of the Quaker, man. You see? Field, man, the green stand for the field, man. Believe that. This is where it all started for me, man. Ninth grade, man, freshman year, I told them I'm not going to any other school. Feel me? I put my transcripts in early. Feel me? I made sure I went to Franklin. Even though I got kid gals, since the kid started like every hustler, distilling candy from corner stores, take it to school to hustle it. To one day, niggas showed me a different candy they hustle with. Put them ready rocks out his sweaty socks with the mustard tip. He said, I'll look out for any nigga that look out. $100 every day, so I started out as a lookout. He thought I was just a punk, he didn't know I'm a rapper. I hear my little cousin that young. You feel me? Alizea's graduating as a sister.
Yeah, get team doing the thing.
You know, we finna turn up tonight, you feel me? Came to show my support from California, you feel me? Came down here, we pushing that shit. Shout out to Alizea, you feel me? Congratulations, girl. Thank you. Let me bring you in here, show you where it's at, though. It's popping in, you feel me? Finna turn up later.
You young people who best embody the Franklin spirit, the Be Franklin spirit. There are so many of you that are so deserving, and I ask staff and I ask committed others to give you some insight. Who can we bring to this stage to hold up our highest level of awesomeness?
See, we in this bitch. I told you I was coming, you feel me?
Ms. Lucas.
Now you see us, man, all green, man.
And Mr.
From first generation Quakers to the third generation.
Jolina Mariano.
Sean Romeo Martindale Jr.
Lanice Martinez.
Jeremiah Tomas Methusalem.
James Dolente Mina. Mohammed.
So with that, I would like to ask the class of 2016 to please rise. Everybody ready? Would everyone please move their tassels from the right to the left? Congratulations, class of 2016!
and your helpers. Andrea Collins.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
talking about from way back, man. Brother's still together, though. He's healthy and he's good, man. Caught him at the Franklin graduation. This is good people, man. The Williams family, I love them to death, man. For real.
The look of a lady, it's not like
I got my number real quick.
What was I-5's first job?
Shit, right? To be honest, man, my first job was right here on this block. He's showing you Martin Luther King, you feel me? I went to Madrona Middle School right up this hill. Every morning, man, I come down here to what used to be called Rogers. Before it was a grocery outlet, it was Rogers. Rogers, motherfucker, and I would come and snatch all my candy up from Rogers, go up the hill and sell them $1 a piece. So I had that bundle at school like nobody else, man. Anybody who remember me know I had candy at school. Eighth grade, Madrona Middle School, you feel me? Take a look at that. Take a look at that right there, man. That shit was not grocery outlet. I repeat, it was not grocery outlet. For you youngins who don't know shit, that was Rogers. And I get all my candy in the morning here.
See in Seattle, I be studying the general's legacy in the battle. Like Napoleon, loading the 30 rounds of petroleum. Swear to God, you niggas remind me of Nickelodeon. Slide through, sweeping shit up like a custodian. Mob conferences, I'm the one that's up on the podium. Spokesman for the squad in the same position that Kobe in. I'm Obi-Wan Kenobi and looking for niggas hoping. Other people's money, yeah, the acronym is OPM. Got the tip off 2 o'clock, had him hit at 4 p.m. I don't deal with no PM, S and that mean no BM. Stressing, so I'm testing all the bitches that I know be in. Vesting in a hustler, can't trust her, I tell her, show me then. Testing if she really got money, then she can show me 10. Plans up in the bank account, plans I gotta take.
That was me, I'm back here, buddy. Welcome to Southwest. This is the alternative school I went to when I was a youngin', man, before I moved to Arizona. I got kicked out, man. But you know how it goes. I'm gonna show it to you. This is where all the kids who was bad went to, man. This is Southwest Alternative School, man. I was there when I was like 15, man, over here on the West. Feel me? Shout out to the West. And I went to High Point Elementary School, like I said on my mixtape. You feel me? Here, watch this. I fuck with the West. I fuck with everybody from the highway to the South and you know. And the district. But this right here, you know how many memories is up in here right now? Southwest, man. Alternative school, man. This was off the chain. Anybody who remembers, this was off the chain, man.
Welcome to Thistle Brick Road. This is West Seattle, man. I grew up out here, too. This is the school I went to. Shoes, you feel me? Blue flannel shirt, crept out and shit coming through school. Teachers didn't stop me, and I appreciate that, man. They let me be locked out, or I would have never went to school. But yeah, y'all remember me, though, you feel me? The only nigga from Seattle and LA. But let me take you into school. This is Chief Self High School, man. This is where I went to school at, man. This is when I came back to Seattle. From California, I had went to high school in Arizona. I came back here, man. They told me that I had to get my GED. They said, you better stay in school, you feel me? Or we're gonna do something. They had some type of term back then. I can't remember what it was called. Youth at risk, you feel me? So you had to be in school. This is Chief Self International High School, man. I got so many memories in here. I remember there was this bad El Salvadorian girl. Man, I could never get her. I'd try every day. I was just too locked out for her, I guess. It's crazy, back in those days, we had a connection out here with the West, so we didn't have no problems. This is known as Thistle Brick Road right here, where we stand at. I stayed right on 16th and Thistle.
You feel me? My grandma's house right there on 16th and Thistle, where we just left from. And it was amazing the shit you see out here.
Graduation, man, you know what I'm saying? Out here pushing it for the home team, you know what I mean? Went to Franklin and Chief Self. I'm gonna show you the Chief Self side of me. You feel me? I-5 like the interstate. We gotta go in here, and I'm gonna show you how we do it at Chief Self. You feel me? From the south into the west, man. Let's come on in. Show you what's going down out here, man. It's about to be popping, man. We finna turn up for the Chief Self shit, you know what I'm saying? Sky blue and red is the colors I came in red. I didn't have no sky blue, but it's all good.
Come on, David. Jackson.
Yeah! Jimmy Swan.
party. Let me show you where it's at in the parking lot. You feel me? Man, it's poppin'. Good people of West Seattle, man. Out here, man. Cheese Shelf High School, West Seattle, man.
Facebook gangster, niggas trying hella hard to make they face look gangster. Posing pictures, apparel smoking, leave body stiff. It's frozen swishes in Seattle, we sliding on frozen sixes. Riding on hoes and snitches and taking care of this business. 10 racks to the shooter, who taking care of this witness? If you won't accept the offers, then I'll stamp the nigga. Light him up inside his office like a lamp, my nigga. I give a fuck what it costs for shooters, got pistols for prosecutors.
This is the apartments I grew up in right here. Right here on 30. 35th and Southwest Morgan Street, right here. So as you can see, I fucked around from Holly to motherfucking Holly, from the south end to the west. You feel me? My apartment's right behind us. I'm gonna take you in the right near. This is High Point where I went to elementary school. I'll show you something. High Point, man. I grew up right fucking here, man. I remember fighting 8 motherfuckers right here. 8 people, man. High Point, man.
Push from High Point to Ranier Ave, and every day just to play, man. What can I say? Went to school at High Point, never since we came. I was living in the projects on 35th. What you know about Southwest Morgan Street? We got your dad on the washouts down the street. That's some shit that you niggas wasn't around to see. I'm a real seat.
Get the stairs, man. Walk up there every day, man. Those are the stairs, man. We're gonna take you to the stairs. This is the front of the school. If you want, I remember I used to walk from the projects. I stayed right on the side on 35th and Southwest Morgan. I have to walk these steps every day. Let me show you, man. Mark. And welcome to High Point Elementary, man. This is where I went from pre-K on up to 6th grade, you feel me? This shit was cracking, man. This is where all my friends know me from, whether you from the south end or the west. Y'all remember me at High Point, man. Ran the school, man. It was crazy. It was lovely, man. This is where it all started, man. This is where I learned the game of chess, which I feel life is like a game of chess. You understand me? You gotta play your moves right. I guarantee, I'm telling you, I have one of the best chess teachers ever. Yes, one of the best ones ever. Shout out to Mr. Hall. And I want to say that that chess taught me how to think. Taught me how to think, man. That's one of the things that was great from the High Point experience here.
and just running back and forth through these hallways. Check it out. This is where I got my first score. Right here, man. In those hallways. Guys, right here where I used to, all my childhood memories is right here. For those who don't know, I went to High Point from kindergarten to fifth grade. I stayed on 35th Southwest Morgan in the apartments on the corner. And I experienced the West Seattle life out here. And you know, now everybody's looking down on a negative void, not understanding the community here we had as High Point, from Ethiopians to Somalians to African Americans to even the Latinos that we seen. Everybody in the community was all together. Split,
man.
It hurts to know it's split, man. You know how much energy right now is on my feet coming to here? You know how many fights I've had right here? You know how many times I raced up out of here getting out of the hill rain? Then we all gather right here.
Yeah, man.
I'm gonna tell you why I love High Point, man. Bricks, man. This is the fucking bricks, man. In the bricks, all kids are outside kids. They don't have that like video gaming playing mentality. These are down to earth people who know how to be their self and have fun together, whether we was rolling down hills or whatever we was doing. You know? The innovativeness to be self. I'm trying to still, you know, show people that we can still be that as we're older. We just gotta stay connected.
Yeah. Man, this feels real heavy right now.
Yeah, gentrification here, High Point hard. Everybody knows that. Anybody, if you're really from High Point, come on, man. I stayed out here, man. This is my other side. This is my other side. Everybody know me out here, man. Swack used to play up there. Everybody knows Swack. That's the little league football team right here. Where you would get smacked. He was a Ranier Eagle, man. It wasn't nothing. They was outside of our district. But Swack was right here. I never chose up to Swack, though. I remained a Ranier Green. You feel me? But shout out my Swack, though. They changed the name of High Point because they didn't want the High Point where it was the bad negativity that they said the name had associated with the neighborhood. What does that mean? We've never had a problem with the term High Point. We never have. We never had a problem with the name High Point. We love High Point. And then they changed it to West Seattle. You have to ask yourself what's going on behind all this. All the new building, who is it helping? All the new building of these condos. Now check this out, that's where I grew up. Look how nice they make this shit for these cats. We got a drug infested crime neighborhood. Now look at it. Is this to say I hold a grudge? No, this is something we should all observe. I live on 35th and Southwest Morgan. My motherfucking house is the projects. Who builds schools next to projects? Ask yourself that. And why? We used to have to walk up these stairs every day. Squabbling right here. This is where it all goes down. This was back when the washhouse was right here. Shout out to Guyatu, man. Shout out to Guyatu, you already know. Her dad had the washhouse right here. You come get all your candy, your chips, everything right here in the middle of the jets. Man, it was lovely through here though, man. So many memories from right here. I know this place is actually hugging me right now. Let's go.
This is High Point, man. This is it. Look at it, they got walkways. Look how they make it. They got lights for them all the way down, LED that can follow you all the way through.
Was it like that before?
Fuck no.
No?
No LED lights, you damn sure needed them.
Not even walkways.
Never walkways. Look at this. Study cause and effect, okay? Look at this. No empty bottles, nothing like that.
So you said it wouldn't look like, it didn't look like this at all?
Never. It did not look like this.
None of these nice little...
No, they made it look like a playland through here, man. They redid all of this.
How long ago would you say this happened?
Man. I remember when it started happening, I was out of town living in California. But every time I came back, I noticed it was getting wider. I came back again, I noticed it was getting wider. I came back again and people looked at me to make me try to feel uncomfortable in my own neighborhood when I walked around.
Around what time was it the most significant?
Man.
I know these
things. It came so subtle and it came
righteous.
Systematically, so you can't really
tell
when it was. Because, you know, the person who designs that makes sure that you can't clock it that way. It's not just, you don't just go into designing and change your folks' neighborhoods without doing it in a subtle way to where they can't detect it. The time that you're going to do it and the time that it's going to be done, you know. This is High Point, man. This is my other side of the stomping grounds right here in West Seattle. Me, my sister went to High Point. My mom went to High Point.
So there's a lot of memories that tie into this for you.
Yeah, because it's like all my dad's side of the family from LA, so I would get my experience down there for that. But right here in Seattle, all my family grew up right here, man. South and in the West. I went to Chief Self High School. I went to Southwest right there on Delridge. You feel me? I went right here to High Point. I've been in the West, and I love the West. But that's what you don't see. You don't see the South and the West and everybody coming together. They don't understand that it's still Seattle. We're still natives at the end of the day. It's a native thought to try to protect your territory. It's a native thought for you to have problems on your territory and not realize why, and that comes in the ways that you express yourself over-aggressively.
So people take this shit as a wrong. They take it aggressive. They take it as extreme. But It ain't nothing like that. It's like somebody's destroying your memories. Somebody's destroying your place that you call home. That's as well as a lot of other families. I mean, I understand where this is coming from. My question is really how... Well, we know how it's happening, but why?
The reason it's happening is because all the project houses are all being cleaned up, coincidentally, right when every other things are on the rise. You have to follow the money. You have to see what rises when they clean things up. Who moves in? What rises? Keep your eye on the dollar. Because everything that's happening affects you. The dollar that's in your pocket, in your family's pocket, believe that. I grew up right here, man. Right here. 5 grades in a row, man. Graduated from High Point Elementary School. It's called West Seattle now. I guess the name wasn't, High Point wasn't good enough. I guess we were that bad of a people as in High Point to where we couldn't even hold on to our own name. Now they're gonna define our name for us. They're gonna define the community.
And they didn't even live here.
None of them. None of them. Who voted for that? You gotta ask yourself. Not our teachers, not the students. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Man, that's just rough. That's rough.
Yeah.
That's heavy. And I
got
feel like
so many memories right here. This is what we're talking about. We're talking about another's benefits for another's memories. What do you think is worth more, money or memories? Sometimes you got to count your memories.
Right. Hell yeah. You would say a lot of these kids is just, they don't even know what the fuck has been going on, huh?
Not at all. Man. Not at all.
One last thing.
I want to thank y'all for walking with me through one of my first, man. It was many out here. I stayed in the South End, and then I had to move to 35th Southwest Morgan. I used to have to get into it over here a whole lot, man. I'm talking about fighting 8-9 people. One time I had the whole school fighting, man. It was crazy. Everybody who went to High Point remember that. I had the teachers chasing me, the whole school, the whole principal. They called up everybody I knew, all my family members, to try to get down there, to try to catch me, because no one could catch me. It was wild. Those are the great memories that showed my leadership way back then. Why was I running from everybody that day? Everybody remembers that. Everybody remembers that, where the whole school stopped and everybody tried to chase me. And I ran from school. You know what I mean? Ask yourself why.
Going against the Empire? So no. This M.O.A.B. for those who don't know. Everybody wanna claim the mob. M.O.B. I'm claiming the M.O.A.B. Moabites, Moabite Nation, Moors. You don't hear about them in school, but I teach you. There ain't a rope for you, but I'll reach you. Real life shit. So those who wanna know, come holler at the mob, the real mob. It ain't all about just selling dope, foreign cars, diamonds and shit, them blood diamonds, man. This shit come from Africa, man. Y'all niggas better know the origin of the shit you consume, nigga. For real, captivate your mind. You making a smooth transition into a sucker, you don't even know it. So when a nigga come and approach you on that shit, you like, why you talking to me like that? Cause I see that transition into a sucker. Niggas better understand the shit that I'm saying, man. Sure, I might say nigga, but I'm a mug, man. A brother, a real one. Believe that shit. I'm from Seattle, Washington. Regardless of whatever, man. Ain't no accent in my voice or none of that shit. We ain't trying to sound like no Cali niggas, no New York niggas, no South niggas, man. I'm from Seattle, Washington, homie. 206, nigga. Fuck that other shit, nigga. On anything. Like that. Oh, and one more thing. Just so you niggas don't forget, the mob is forever, nigga. Not diamonds, the mob is forever, nigga. That's our pyramid at the top of that dollar, nigga. That's our eye, they ripped the head off. Put the European eye in there, nigga. That's our symbol, that's our symbolism. They took our shit, that's what happens when infiltration comes in, you feel me? Real shit, but the empire still stands. The empire still stands. The empire still stands. Shout out to the Most High and my comedic ancestors. Peace. We'll be right back.